Alrighty, so show's starting late and everything because, yeah. I'm fairly convinced whatever Streamlabs' problem is, it stems from being trying to be linked with Rumble, because so far as I understand it, Rumble is the only platform that needs a new streamer key and a new link for every single stream, and somehow constantly resetting that shit with Streamlabs. Starting to call you Mr. Second Start. Yeah, great. Having a difficult day as it is, man. So, you know, why not? Why not second, third start? I don't know. Fuck it. Anyways, I got to reload everything since I had to restart the whole computer because, again, Streamlabs doesn't want to work with Rumble and just... We have a variety of hype train videos. If we do a hype train later, we have a lot of videos we can play. While we do this, I'll load up some stories, personal talk, I guess. I'm having a lot of difficulty with my hand and legs, so it's just a rough day. Didn't need the computer to be a piece of shit. But we've completely turned off Rumble, and we're not even touching Rumble today, and we're going to see how that goes.
You might be asking yourself, is
Fuck
Rush Order
off! Sorry about that. Sorry, I'm a Christian. I'm a God-fearing man. Anyways, so let's go ahead and... How's it going otherwise? Not good, honestly. Like, just difficult to do all this shit, and the body is not willing. So we're going to pull up our stories from yesterday that we didn't get to, and then we have a bunch of other ones that we will get into. First, I have to mute another auto-starting piece of shit ad, and then we will go over here and get the next story. I'm sorry. I don't want to be angry, but it's really difficult right now. We have a feel-good story later in the hour. That might help everybody. And then we've got a British woman arrested for praying. Apparently that's a crime in Britain. I realized that you don't have freedom of speech, but I thought prayers was going to be a thing that, you know, free to pray. Especially when you find out she wasn't really doing it, like, intrusively. You know, she's minding her own business. All right, hold on. And we got Pete Buttigieg responding to Fox News host. Jesus Christ. I honestly don't know if I can do a show. Can't control my right hand well enough to use a mouse. In fact, is this one? Is this? No, that's not that. And this is the one from NPR. What? Alrighty. Well, let's go to this anyway then. This is Pete Buttigieg responding to Fox News hosts after some personal attacks.
CNN exclusive interview with the Department of Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg. Speaking to our own Isaac Dover, Buttigieg is acknowledging some mistakes in his response to the East Palestine, Ohio train disaster. And he admits that he should have gone to the devastated community sooner. The accident created a political firestorm with Buttigieg at its center. The transportation secretary has become a target of an almost unrelenting onslaught of professional and very personal attacks from conservative media.
Also from those of us who've used planes and now trains. Quite frankly, if he fucks up the automobiles, he'll have the whole set, all right? No offense. The complaints are real. John Hahn saying, hang in there, Johnny. You still have the dope-ass egg chair. Yeah, and they can bury me in it. Anyways, here we go. Buttigieg. Is it wrong to say his name is Buttigieg? This whole Buttigieg thing. I don't believe Buttigieg. There's no, it's Buttigieg. Buttigieg. As in the Buttigieg of the joke. Messing up automobiles has been a work in progress since the 70s. Well, I thought now they were just convincing us to buy the electric ones that suck ass.
What is he, 150 pounds wet?
Not even a size small construction vest fits this guy. It's draping off of him. He looks like he's wearing a costume.
If Pothole Pete seems lazy and out of touch to all of you, that is because it's true.
There's never been a cabinet secretary this flamboyantly incompetent and this so obviously uncaring, almost to the point of evil, if we're being honest about it.
All right, so, yeah, of being evil. Yeah, they're getting a little hyperbolic at the end there. But explain to me where they were wrong in all the statement of the facts. And the fun... Oh, fuck, camera's off. And the fun part is... Yay, you're here. Hi, says Sandy Squatch. Yeah, I am here. I'm pretty sure that the whole problem is the goddamn fucking Rumble. Fucking Rumble. So we're not on Rumble today just because there's a whole process to set up a Rumble stream. You don't sound sick. I can't walk, dude. I'm sorry if not being able to walk is a problem. Welcome to multiple sclerosis. Look, I don't know what you might have heard. I texted Aaron. I can't make it in MS bullshit. So literally what that meant was there was no way I was going to be able to walk in. And every time I've gone in like this, they always say, dude, if you don't feel that good, it's all right, man. At least this guy doesn't wear a dress like that Department of Transportation freak they fired earlier. Yeah. And that wasn't a Department of Transportation person. That was a nuclear energy. Something to do with either nuclear energy or nuclear waste disposal. I don't remember what. But something to do with the Energy Commission, because he had something to do with nuclear energy. That's why he was in Minnesota, because he had to come up to the reactor they have up here. So, thought you were faking the legs. Nope, totally not. And today they're so stilty, I almost couldn't do this show. Because I don't know if you're aware, but just walking in. And then also, the hand isn't doing well. And so doing Aaron's show and then this show takes a lot out of me, and I have two medical appointments tomorrow and one on Thursday, and since my legs were all shitty, and I literally was like, oh, this is going to be difficult, I just decided to just take it off. Rumor is you got beat up by 2 9-year-olds. I mean, if it took two of them, fuck them. At least I won in that regard. You know, that's a victory for me. You couldn't handle me on your own, you little bastard. And I don't know why people think I can't take kids. It's not like I'm not willing to stab them. And that's the thing. They could get my knife from me and stab me, but there's a lot more of me to get through, right? 2 inches does a lot more damage over there. Oh, jokes. These are jokes, folks. Alrighty, so yeah, back to CNN talking about new FAA leader. All I know about him is he's not a pilot. Oh yeah, I heard about that. Jesus, even worse. You could just beat him with your cane. Honestly, this is the sad thing about that. I can't swing or move a lot. My center of gravity is incredibly unstable, especially right now. I am losing a lot of ability to control my lower back and midsection, so it's a super fun time to be me. And yeah, and then the legs are extending and not retracting, so I literally spent the first hour of my day today walking on my tiptoes. Very awkwardly. I had to use a walker to get around my house. Wasn't fun. And still using the walker. Still not fun. But moving on, Tucker Carlson might be going a bit far with almost to the point of being evil, if we're honest about it. Like, that's, no, that's your opinion, and that's a little bit much. But no, this dude does seem incredibly incompetent with the fuck-up of the airlines that we're still dealing with, the fuck-up of so many trains. Didn't we even cover another train yesterday? I don't know. Either we covered a train yesterday, or spoiler alert, I have one somewhere in here today. But, Jesus, I'm sorry to hear that. That's why I don't really talk about it much. Like, I know Aaron is a very, like, hey, we're here, we're real, this is what's going on show. Like, a lot of people are like, hey, man, you know, I keep stuff on the back burner because it's kind of a bump. Thank you. Thank you very much for that shart, Joe Berger and the 250 channel points. Walking on my tiptoes, now that does suck. The worst part is, like, it'd be cool if I got stronger from doing that kind of shit. Just wears my legs out. Not even toned. I still look like, you know, If I'm naked, I still like a flesh-colored Kool-Aid, man. That's pretty much what it is. If you cut off my head and threw me through a wall going, oh, yeah, people are like, well, that's the wrong shade, but kind of. It'd work. So anyways, it's all roses over here. Thank you for being part of the show today. Again, if we do have a hype train, we have several videos. I have a couple of short little ones that are fun, and I've got several that are just hilarious. I have a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and I think a couple of those ones are short, so I'll call a couple of the two ones in the beginning of one. So we'll say we have 7 videos. Your body's just not able to build or maintain muscle, I'm assuming. I don't know which it is. We fatigue quick, and then we got to take a nap, and when we get up, we're not a whole lot better. Meh. So I've been moving through sheer force of will, but after several recent really strange, really short, intense, strange headache episodes, I have an MRI tomorrow. That's fun. I'm sorry we don't have to talk about it. Move on with the show. We're already here. Anyways, let's get back to Tucker Carlson. Oh, boy.
Buttigieg is now hitting back, telling CNN, it's really rich to see some of these folks, the former president, these Fox hosts who are literally lifelong card-carrying members of the East Coast elite who wouldn't know their way around a TJ Maxx if their life depended on it, to be presenting themselves as if they genuinely care about the forgotten middle of the country. You think Tucker Carlson knows
the... What the fuck does TJ Maxx and Kohl's have... This is the most bullshit chicken fight thing between... Look, all of your digs were shitty. Buttigieg. And by the way, lady, it's pronounced Buttigieg. I don't mean a mansplain. Buttigieg. It's nothing to do with your gender. It's just you're saying his name's wrong. It's Buttigieg, not Buttigieg. Buttigieg. Even if it isn't, I'm saying it is. And I identify as I'm right. Anyways,
Cheer 100, I wonder if you took 2 blue pills that would keep both legs up and a boner as a crutch.
Nope, that's not how that works. If I took 2 blue pills, I'd be dead in, like, about probably, what? I don't know right now with what's going on internally if I should take any blue pills, if we're honest. Like, I'm pretty sure right now we're on the stay calm, carry on, but don't cause strange changes in blood pressure kind of thing. I don't know. We'll find out more tomorrow after some in-depth brain scans, although I suppose they won't get the results for like a week. So I'm still on the be calm, carry on sort of scenario. Alrighty, but back to this. Buttigieg saying people are presenting themselves whether or not they go to TJ Maxx or Kohl's. And thank you for the 100 bits, by the way. I didn't acknowledge that. I'm sorry. Get drunk. Definitely probably shouldn't do that.
Cheer 100.
Thank you, King of Clubs, for the 100 bits. That's super awesome. Thank you. But yeah, so presenting themselves if they genuinely care about TJ Maxx. Here's the, I think we're kind of done with this. Here's the problem with that. Their burns on you were incredibly lame, and your burns back were even worse, okay? Their burns on you could have been so, like, he's incompetent. Have you flown? I don't fly. TJ Maxx and Kohl's are considered poor people stores.
Oh, no. Here comes a train, a busy little train, rushing up and down on the daisy line. Mummies and daddies, the grandpas and the grannies, everyone's right, aboard on the 809. Here comes a train, and here comes driver 10-2. Wahey! Here it comes, here it comes, here comes a train to stay. Here comes a train!
I gotta cut that new, hold on to my fur intro. Is this thing cleared out? Not really. Kind of. Sort of. Alrighty. TJ Maxx and Kohl's are considered poor people stores. Now, that's what the companies are getting at. The comparison was getting at, like, saying AOC wouldn't know her way behind a Home Depot. Do you mean her way inside a Home Depot? I feel like... Behind a Home Depot. Now, in front of a Home Depot, I'd say you're making an illegal immigrant worker joke. Bravo, but no. Behind a Home Depot. That sounds like an AOC is a whore joke. Which, by the way, she's on the she's under investigation. I think we covered that yesterday, or is that in our docket today? Pretty sure that's yesterday that we covered that. Thank you, Wilmer, for the 20 bits and the chunky rain. We love the support we have on this show. Very, very grateful for everything we've had. That's why we're continually doing our mandatory overtimes, because the support has been amazing, and we are very grateful.
Cheer 100 boner 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 boner.
Thank you very much, 5W40 Motor Oil. Kohl's is high-end for poor people. Well, then what's Walmart? Is Walmart low-end for poor people? Funny, isn't it? Yes. Apparently I nailed it. That is low-end for poor people. I'm going to have to pop up, and excuse me while I do this, I'm going to pop up a second window to keep a track of the Twitch train situation. Don't want to miss that. Have to reopen all... Reopen? Really, dude. Definitely don't drink. Have to reopen all of my windows because, you know, of course, we had to restart everything. Pretty sure that, again, it has to do with that. Alrighty, so that hype train is sitting there at 26% with 2 minutes left. We have, we'll do our first two videos for our hype train stuff. Uh-oh. Thank you, Wilmer, for the taco night. Oh. Oh, that's extensive. King of Clubs with, 1,500 bits. Jesus, man. Thank you. That puts us over into
cheer
level 2.
Cheer 1,000. Cheer 100. Cheer 100. Cheer 100.
That is
cheer
so awesome.
100,
thank
cheer
you.
Cheer 100.
We've got our second video coming up here that I'm already loading too, and then we'll see where that puts us. I'm sure that's in or past level 2, so we're going to do both of these videos for level 1. Oh, wait. No. Alrighty. So that's level 2, and depending on what that third video is, I might ditch that if that's... Yeah, that's the one. It's just some dude singing. It sucks. I don't know. Maybe we'll watch it if it provokes a funny reaction. We're in level 2 of that hype train with 4 minutes and 20 seconds. Haha, timing. So we're going to go ahead and get into this first video. Now, this video is of a millionaire explaining the mindset of an online social media influencer. There we go. Okay, so there we go.
Not being a narcissist and having
Frankerzy 100,
like, you know,
higher.
Yes. Thank you, dear book.
Like, yeah, like it's
interesting.
Oh, yeah, it's like, you know, to be successful on social media, it can be up to two things. You're either a complete narcissist and you just love yourself to the ultimate extent, or you have a true passion to help people. And you really, you know, you think about that young 8-year-old kid that you want to touch and you know, help him grow and become
okay, well,
better. And,
what do you,
know,
mean touch?
Think, you know, you're either tapping into that vibe, right, or you're tapping into the I'm the greatest thing in the world, you know?
Yeah, there's a reason that, wow, you just turned me up. There's a reason that the word selfish and selfie have the same root.
Yeah.
So it's like, where did that come from? So these selfie things, listen, it's different for
really
men and
good
women.
They do on Instagram, though, by the way.
What do?
Faces in general.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Like you should even like, you could even put a face that's not even there in your pictures. Like make it so the eye can't see it, but the robots could, and your post will actually do better.
Why are we touching kids? That's exactly what I'm talking about.
Yeah, just in general, just having a face in the
even
image.
Not
where
your
did this
face,
come up?
Someone else's face? Oh, that's
well, yeah, you could just there. Put a, the, you could actually put a face in the image, but it can't be seen by eyes, but like the robots can see it, and it'll actually help your engagement.
So that's
you can
interesting.
Just, like,
scaring
you just fade
me.
A face.
So nah, I'm going
to
put a selfie
are
of you on my
like
page.
A, just selfie, like it doesn't have
is that
like
guy Ben Affleck? I feel like Ben Affleck is sitting in this. And why do we have like... Three different women.
No, yeah, no, faces do really well. Yeah.
I've noticed that on my Instagram
they
that
do.
You're saying that.
No, yeah, no, Instagram.
Because I've been putting pictures up of my face and my titties, and I gotta say right now, it's a 2-to-1, but not the way you'd think. Thank you, Sandy Squatch, for the awkward fart and the 100 bits. We're at 34% of level 2 of this hype train, continuing right along.
Most that I do where it's just my face and uh-huh. like here up, yeah. they do really
they
good.
They do really good, yeah.
Yeah, they yeah, do no, really good. Imagine this, her navel up to her face. They do really good. I can't imagine anything between those two that might get, I don't know, anyone interested. Can we do any math on how many of those over under included cleavage, madam?
Instagram.
So, word to the wise, ladies, you don't have to do booty shots.
No.
No. She just pointed out that the face does well, but the titties. Never gonna give you up. Never gonna let you down. Thank you, dear Butch, for the 500 bits in the Rickroll. I got a controlled burn number one coming in here. Oh, I know tits has fallen. Thank you, Kay Fallen. Thank you for being a part of the show. Controlled burn, damn titties. That's right. Ass and titties. All right, controlled burn number one.
Thought I was
just hone
pretty.
In on the face.
Yeah. Well, you know, I mean, obviously you're pretty, but it's, you know, yeah, but
I
the face
like,
is general.
Okay, like my face. Yeah. No, it's just out.
Albatrax, hey, what's up, Johnny? Hey, welcome to the show. Hey, thank you for joining us. I mean, I'm honest. These two ladies here, they have good faces. But let's be honest. The titties are going to get more clicks. All right? I'm just sorry. Men are thirsty. It's the way it is.
BJ, let me ask you one more question about social media, and then we'll transition to a little more money success topics. You, million followers, Instagram, do you prefer a girl who is, let's say, a million also followers? She's out there. She's putting a thing. Or... a girl.
I mean, to be honest, a
couple hundred followers, private.
I don't
not,
really care
not trying
about
to put
that.
Her stuff out there.
I don't really care about that. But.
All right, yeah, fuck this guy. I don't want to hear about his dating life. I was just interested about the pot calling the kettle black, Mr. Million Followers on Instagram, big on social media. Yeah, you're either out there to help people or you're a total, like, I'm better than everybody else narcissist. I'm going to let you guys guess which one he was. But anyways, I got my theories. Let's move into the next video. Who pulled that jump scare? Oh, Wilmer. Thank you for the 25 bits. 64%. That's what we're going to tap out on that train, which is fine. Thank you. Let's go ahead and just reload this page.
I want to tell you how my morning started.
Okay.
And normally, I hold the phone when I had these conversations with y'all about what's going on in my life, but I
get
need both hands for this video. You see, I woke up at 6:30 this morning when my alarm went off because I got to take my babies to school. I roll out of bed, I wipe my eyes, still kicking myself for not pulling out. I walk into my daughter's room, flip on the light, and she is full on whipping the shit out of the air. I'm talking about Mike Tyson haymakers to the air. Had the air been a person, it would have to immediately been airlifted to the nearest hospital. I wake her up, Scoot, you okay, baby? Do I get greeted with a good morning, daddy? How are you? No, I get greeted with a really daddy right in the middle of me whooping him. Whooping who, Scoot? She said, I don't know, but I asked them to find something safe to do, and they kept poking the bear. She said, now turn the lights off. Give me 5 minutes so I can finish these Hefners. You know what? I think you mean heifers, not Hefners, but I'm going to turn the light off. Hurry up. We ain't got all morning for this. I want to tell
you. I love this dude. He's hilarious. Albatrax talking about that last guy saying he looks like dollar store logic. Yeah, that guy looked pretty fucked up. The reason he was there is he's the person he was describing. He is one of those narcissists that's completely into himself. He had way too many followers. But anyways, those two were all right. The third one was one we're not going to do. So we might do this because, nah, we'll save it. If we get another one later, we'll burn through those. Otherwise, we have them for later in the week. Because, spoiler alert, if you're a fan of the show starting and immediately restarting
Cheer
right now.
100, did you watch the Chris Rock special? I watched it last night and it was so.
I have not gotten around to watching it because I was busy making emails with peoples yesterday after the show. And I was busy getting a sound drop, which I haven't even. Oh, we'll put the new sound drop on the board. I've almost got the image done for the sticker, but we can put the sound drop up right now. Actually, can I do it this way? I believe I can, and I did. I just have to grab it. There we go. All right, there we are. Okay, so I gotta fucking grab one sound. I'm sorry, this is incredibly unprofessional. No one should like this show. But don't DSP now. But to reward you guys for that hype train, other than those two videos that we had fun with for a minute, 6:30, lazy ass. I've already been to work for 2 hours at that point. Get a real job, pussy. Yeah, he's getting up at 6:30 to wake up his daughters. I think he's actually a real-life police officer. I can't say that for a fact, but I believe... I follow that guy's YouTube stuff. I love his shorts. They're hilarious. His officer How does he pronounce that? Like Yundi? I don't know. I can't stand Chris Rock, says Sandy Squatch. Well, I don't agree with you there. I think Chris Rock might be fun. I'm worried I might have seen the best part of Chris Rock on, where are we? No. Why is this? All right, so video, music, game over drops. B and the M's. There we go. We've got a new drop here. Let's move it into folder one. And let's go. I think it'll work at about this. We'll test it at this volume.
Mary Lovestick.
All right, there we go.
Mary Lovestick.
So, spoiler alert, there's a sticker coming with that very soon. Okay, so there we go. Congratulations. Madagascar equals his best work. Oh, my God. See ya. Gotta go. Have a great show. Thank you for being part of it, Albatrax. Thank you so much. Alrighty, so that's those two videos and that done, and that's the Buttigieg story we've got completed. Why do we have that tab open? That's strange. Chris Rock, How to Not Get Your Ass Kicked by the Police is a classic. I can't say I remember that off the top of my head. I'm gonna be honest, there's difficulties with the old brain case at the moment. I think I still have one controlled burn left to do. We've only just begun to do a show, and we have a whole 3.5 hours of content prepped, which we will get back into. And I thought Sprinkle a Little Crack, wasn't that? I thought that was a Dave Chappelle thing. Correct me if I am wrong, but I believe. Oh, and I got some articles coming across the whole thing there. I should check that quick. Yeah, why not? Let's do show prep now. Hard to tell. What do you mean, hard to tell? You can't tell the difference between Chris Rock and Dave Chappelle? Their names are totally different. Their height's totally different. One of them has, like, hair and the other one's bald. I mean, there's some pretty stark contrasts, sir. Let us not cast disillusions. Alrighty, let's see what this is. YouTube. This is a clip of Aaron saying, "Fingers off my nipples." Okay. I don't know if I want to know about that. Thank you for linking that. I thought that would be more show important than it was. Anyways, we're going to catch up on a story we talked about earlier. What up, cuz? I don't think I say that right, Brown Candy. Johnny, I sent you a funny Aaron clip you can use for a sound drop. Okay, so a funny clip I can use for a sound drop. Let's hear this clip.
I know. It works for LeBron James to draw fouls. Do you get your fingers off my... I know. It works for LeBron James to draw fouls. Do you get your fingers off my... I know.
Get your fingers off my...
It works for LeBron James to draw fouls. Do you get your fingers off my...
I mean, I think you might have missed a bit, but okay, I get what you're saying. I don't know if that one... Get your fingers off my and then drop out completely might work, but we'll see. Yours didn't work like mine. Okay. Chris Rock just screams about everything. Dave Chappelle is actually funny. Dave Chappelle did sketch comedy, and I disagree on the Chris Rock not being funny. I think there are some very, very funny things that Chris Rock did. Why the is this? Oh, because I'm on a fucking Facebook feed. I'm like, what the is this bullshit? Oh, now I'm so easily thrown off today, and I wish it were because I was highly medicated, but it's not, and that is almost. So this is for me, Johnny. That's because Chris Rock does coke and Chappelle's a stoner. C See, that's where you got me at a loss. I love Chris Rock. I idolize him as a comedic performer in certain ways. And I'll say this. I love smoking weed. I am now Tim Pool, a man with a fence up his ass. Mine said nipples, I'm a failure. Well, you might not have clipped it, or someone else might have clipped it. Here's the best thing to know about a sound clip. A little snippet on either end isn't a bad idea. Think of sound clips like uncircumcised penises. Having that extra end makes it easy for someone if they have to cut it later. But otherwise, if there's no problem, it's just there. Chris Rock's special seems slapped together in a quick paycheck. And maybe it was, but I don't think he needs one. But you never know. You never know. All right, so that's the Buttigieg thing. We're going to catch up on a story we were talking about earlier with two Americans that were kidnapped in Mexico are back in the U.S. and two others were two of the four Americans who were held captive and survived a kidnapping in Mexico last week have been repatriated back to the U.S. with the assistance of the Mexican government, the State Department confirmed on Tuesday. One of the victims is reportedly injured, but officials provided no information on their current condition. State Department spokesman Ned Price said officials are in the process. I suppose I could put this up on the screen if anyone else wants to read. Are in the process of repatriating the remains of the other two who were found dead in the border state of Tamaulipas. Again, the whole thing about this, for those that don't remember, was it was they were not the targets. These are not the victims you are looking for. And it cost two of them their lives. That has got to be shitty. Two people are dead because of mistaken identity. Yeah. So I told you they lie? What? Shunt me harder. Where did... What? It was better than Roseanne Barr's new stand-up. I'm convinced Roseanne Barr's new stand-up is boomer bait. All right? That's what the whole thing is. Roseanne Barr, and she pitched it in the right place. I'm sure the cartels feel bad, says Fecko. Oh, yeah. I would love... We go now live to the cartels. We are incredibly disappointed with this outcome. We here in the Mexican drug cartels hate to see any needless loss of life, particular of anyone who could become a future customer. I mean, I feel like it was a failure on our part to have just needlessly murdered them when we could have gotten them onto a solid, continuing, manageable, habitual drug habit. You know... Or as established medicine calls them now, vaccines. Oh, man. Anyways. Wait a minute, what? Rusty Grammar, you stay for breakfast. It's... Tamaulipas. Okay. I can't read very well, apparently. All right. So, 5W40, I'm out till Thursday. Hope you feel better. You know, I'm doing the best I can. Thank you for that. And we'll see you Thursday. Again, Thursday's show hopefully won't start late. I have to go to the cities to continue getting the rest of this shit looked at. So, we're going to do that. So I don't want to really keep going on that one. Plus, we're coming to the end of the first hour, and we're already getting a little behind, so we need to get that done. We talked about Buttigieg, freaking Buttigieg lady. Okay, Michael Moore is demanding a nationwide? Michael Moore demands a nationwide boycott of Walgreens for not selling the abortion pill, saying it is bigotry and misogyny. Michael Moore claims Walgreens more proved that they stand with anti-abortion extremists. Now, I think for a bit of clarification here, he is calling for a boycott after the pharmacy chain announced it would not sell the abortion pills in 20 states. And those 20 states are because those states have rules against the abortion laws. So let's just be clear. Map saying, hi, how are you? Hey, we're great. Booty gig. Buttigieg, Booty Greg, Booty Gag, Butt Peg, I don't know. I sure wish Michael's mom would have been able to find that pill 50 years ago. California. Yeah, here's the funny thing about this, though. He's calling for a nationwide... You do it once and you just figure, fuck, we'll swim in it, right, you dumbass? He's calling for a nationwide ban on this shit because the store is choosing to agree with the rights of certain states, right? So because the state doesn't really want people having abortions, Walgreens like, we're not going to carry the pill. So what this comes down to is he's like, look, man, these guys aren't willing to stand up to the state by saying we'll sell drugs even if you don't want us to. Nationwide is on your side. Thank you, Fat Conan. Nationwide is, it's not going anywhere. Michael, I ate too many cheeseburgers more is worthless. Look, I just feel like Michael Moore doesn't realize one simple truth. It's like, dude, Michael, these states might get rid of the abortion pill, all right? But you call for this ban, then none of those states have access to the abortion pill. But even if you did that and you got rid of the abortion pill nationwide, nailed it. Does he forgot that we still have stairs? Like, I mean, it's not like abortions end. Pete Butt Booty Judge, he sure is. Thank you, Rusty. The grocery store in Annandale, Minnesota doesn't sell condoms because they're against it. Yeah, and it's just like, oh, so now I guess I have to cream pie because there's a con. Like, have people forgotten that in a pinch there's such a thing as a candy wrapper? Look, if you're in, if you have ingenuity, there is always a workaround. And I suppose I made that reference earlier, like, oh, what is he forgot that we have stairs? And I just realized if anyone's forgot that we have stairs, it's Michael Moore. Oh. Filmmaker Michael Moore has called for a nationwide boycott of Walgreens. February 20th, the Republican state attorney general wrote to Walgreens Corp threatening legal action if Walgreens provided the abortion pill. Oh, 20 Republican state attorneys. So here's what happens. The government says don't sell these pills or we'll take legal action. And Michael Moore's like, they're bowing to legal threats from the government. Oh, Brown Candy saying, I sell a pill for abortions. It tastes like M&M's, and the side effect are a punch in the stomach. I don't know if it's just that video game I was playing a little bit this morning when my legs weren't working. Just Deadpool voice comes through for that one. Centricare won't tie tubes or do vasectomies without making you consult a priest, too. Fuck that. Well, I haven't tried to get a vasectomy yet. Haven't really been worried about that. Let's just say there's not a whole lot of action for this pole. So I've got to really worry about what happens if one slides. Like a baseball call. Oh, and it's sliding high and right on the outside. And oh, it hit it right in the vulva. And that's a live drive. That's a line drive to a... Frickin' for, what is it? I don't know. Okay, so maybe I'm just in my own head. Alrighty, let's get rid of this. Michael Moore bitching about Walgreens again. Walgreens' only crime here, to indict the wrath of Michael. I can't believe there's so much of you more. Doctors won't tie girls' tubes until she's 30, just in case she changes her mind and wants to have kids. Yeah, but a vasectomy is very reversible. Kind of like a raincoat. Kay Fallen, making a brilliant point. Vasectomy, vasecta you, vasecta everybody in the room. With that beard, the only thing you need, a fedora, Johnny, says Battle Brothers EO. I actually have a couple of fedoras. Actually, I don't know if they're true fedoras. I have a bowler, a derby, I guess, English derby bowler hat. A couple of toreadors or I don't know. Either way, not worried about it. Moving on. Talking about hot women, this all started when we gave women rights. See, if we would have just kept the rights away from the women, look, Brown Candy, I know, I know that that argument fits very well when we do the stories on the trans stuff, you know, because I feel like that's where, you know, but I feel like just automatically bringing that in is a little weird. They will let you change your gender, though. What? No, I don't want to change my gender. I'm happy with being a dude. I'm just lonely. Like, what are you, the Canadian government? Man, I'm really lonely. Have you ever considered becoming a woman? I don't think that'll solve my problem. Well, I've got a maid who can help you. What do you mean, like room service maid? No, I mean like, close your eyes. We're done now, maid. Women need to be sent to Ukraine. We equal now. Oh, no. Shunt me harder. I don't agree. Don't send the women to... Don't do that. You send the women to Ukraine, like, but only the ugly ones. Whoa, come on. You know what I mean.
All right, we're gonna fix this again for the 20 millionth time until I go buy that Loctite shit that someone said yesterday. That's what happens when you don't go anywhere. You don't get stuff. Then when going somewhere becomes difficult, what do you do?
Alrighty, Hayden Panettiere tears up in her first interview since her brother's death. I think, oh yeah, so we just had this. Wasn't it this thing? Let's mute that for a second. Nope, it wasn't this one. It was further down. I thought there was a video. Well, isn't she busy being a hottie? Alrighty, where is... thought there was an actual video. Apparently, they're very upset. The family released a statement offering a sweet tribute. She mentioned it on, like, a Good Morning America show, and she got kind of teary-eyed about it. The whole point we were going to be talking about that is just to say that they're still not... They're like, oh, well, the cause of death was this enlarged heart thing. They haven't said whether or not there was a history of it. And I'm like, no, there wasn't, okay? There wasn't a history of it because, you know, that's something you would know. All right. I might have to. We'll see about that. It's a difficult thing to think about. But I got that message, dude. Alrighty. Wait, Sandy is going to Ukraine. Hey, now don't throw punches inside the tent. There's plenty of ugly bitches we could have put on the list. I'll give you one. Janine Moos.
Oh, a tough life when a reporter has to pack her bags because she sounds like a 1920s slide horn. Well, Ukraine, you can count me out.
Fucking goddamn it. Nancy Pelosi, hell yeah. You want your tubes tied? How about we give you a dick instead? I mean, I would. It isn't bad enough that MGTOWs think that women shopping caused 9/11. So wait a minute. Hold the phone. You're saying that isn't the case? That's what I thought this whole time. I thought 9/11 was all because there was like a Macy's Day sale and somebody just... Shunt me harder. I give dick, not take dick. I don't know what that matters. What are, what's MGWOTs? Yeah, I don't know. Janine Moos or Nancy Pelosi voice? I was doing Janine Moos. I feel like Nancy Pelosi has a much different voice. Janine Moos always does that stupid fucking cadence, and I hate her voice, and I want her to stop. She needs to stop. She's not getting better with time. You know, she has not gotten better with age at all. Alrighty. Anyways, there's that. So we've got this story I wanted to get to. God damn it, Paul. Where are all the hammers? It was my daughter that wanted her tubes tied. I'm fine, LOL. I don't fault anyone for not wanting to be able to get knocked up. And even if you got your tubes tied, couldn't you technically, like, freeze some eggs and hope that works for you? But then if you freeze some eggs and then you and your husband aren't people of color, but you have a kid that's a little dark, but you both know it was you that contributed, do you officially chalk that up to freezer burn? I mean, I just think, like, you got to, right? You got to. Brown candy, MGTOWs are men who see women, who see the worst in women, saying that they are all gold diggers that are not equal to men in any way, shape, or form. Battle Brother Zio, let me tell you right now, I don't... Brown candy playing into it. So I am an MGTOW. Which do you like better? I mean, oh. I don't know. If brown, maybe your eggs were farm fresh and they were... Oh, yeah, there you go. They were free range. They were the... That's all it was. Those are organic. We're not solving anything now, and that's disappointing because this is a serious show for serious people. All right, so moving on over back into this side of things. Here we go. The Arkansas boy has raised over $100,000 for his favorite Waffle House waiter after he found out he didn't have a car and was living in a motel. Oh, there's the waiter. I was gonna scroll this up a minute. I was gonna say, did you want to see the? Oh, it's because the ad made it jump. I see. There we go. Well, there they are. Isn't that beautiful? He raised $100,000 for this dude just because every day he brought him a milkshake and a waffle with a smiley face on it. And you know what the best part of that whole thing is? The one who made all the food was the cook. He didn't get shit. Schoberger at Brown Candy, you behaving. I don't know what that's all about. Battle Brothers Zio, if that isn't a W, then nothing is. I mean, respect is earned, but let's not give women respect because they have a uterus. Oh, let's just give women respect because they have a uterus. Okay. I mean, I feel like a lot of dudes, I feel like that's a trend. That's a trend and a thing that's started by a lot of dudes. Dudes that are like, I'm just going to give women respect because I want to get laid. These are the same dudes that'll go like, I'll take any woman that comes along just as long as I can get my dick wet. And then people will be like, why haven't you gotten laid? It's because I've chosen to have standards. You know, I guess my standards are at a level where apparently I don't meet the level to achieve them. So I guess it's just, you know, silent times for me. Fat Conan, you hear what Joe Rogan said about Trump versus Biden. No, I didn't. If there's a clip that you want to throw at me, I would be more than happy to play it. It's not respect for me now. It's begging. I have lots of respect for vaginas, says Joe Berger. I like chicks. Well, you know what? You know what I heard about vagina? I heard this about vagina.
Mary Lovestick.
All right. Anyways, let's go back to this. Alrighty, so again, where is this out of? This is an 8-year-old boy out of Little Rock, Arkansas that found out his favorite Waffle House waiter was living in really sad conditions, so he set out to raise money for the man to give him a hand up. The 8-year-old Kazen Hunter from Little Rock, Arkansas. That sounds like someone who's going to commit some sort of a crime later. Oh, Fat Conan with a YouTube link. We'll get into that in just a second. Let's wrap this up and move right over to that. Thank you, Fat Conan. Thank you all for being part of the show today. Let's keep this moving along. The 8-year-old Kason Hunter has a regular ritual of breakfast at his local Waffle House in Little Rock, Arkansas, with his family. Sometimes, I took my hoodie off. I don't remember if I ever. All right, with his family, sometimes with his grandpa, but often with his parents and siblings. With these trips comes his meal served by his favorite waiter, Devontae Gardner. It was about a year ago when they met. My dad started going, and Kazen would go with him. And when he came home, he talked about Devontae and how much he liked him. Kazen's mom, Victoria Hunter, tells Today, adding that the family would go for breakfast just about every weekend. Every time he comes in, I always give him a high five because that's what he expects, Gardner tells Today. Gardner has mesmerized Kazen's usual order, scrambled eggs with cheese, no toast, hash browns covered with cheese, and an Arnold Palmer. Wait a minute, isn't that a drink? There for that. Isn't an Arnold Palmer a drink? Isn't that like an alcoholic beverage? That sounds a little dangerous. Arnold Palmer better than Harry Palmer. Hey. He only likes Devontae because he looks up, because he hooks it up 3 G's for 20. Arnold Palmer is a 50-50 lemonade and tea. Alrighty, there we go. That's just weird. We wanted to find him something affordable, so we moved into a low-income area, Gardner says. We just got tired of infestations with rats and roaches and all this black mold. My daughters were getting sick, no heating and things like that. When it was cold outside, we had to bundle up. It was like 4 or 5 blankets in order to stay warm. It was just horrible, Gardner says, adding that he and his family have been living in a motel for the past 8 months. He came home and told me, hey, Mom, Devontae walks or gets a ride to work, and I'm going to start a GoFundMe, Hunter says, adding that Kazen had begged her for a while to do a GoFundMe before she agreed to take the plunge. I was like, okay, that's really sweet. It's a great idea. With his mom's help, Kazen aimed to raise the modest $500 for Gardner. They posted a GoFundMe to help Devontae get a family car on February 18th. Hi, my name is Kazen. I am 8 years old. Da, 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 da. Kazen explains that Gardner was looking for a decent priced car and that the Hunter family wants to get Gardner's family into a clean rental property. Though the Hunters say the GoFundMe started out slow, as some attention comes to it, the amount and the goal has skyrocketed to over $100,000 as of the publication. He's a positive young kid, and he has a brave, huge, or he has a very huge heart. Where did I get brave out of that? Yeah. And I'm thankful he came into my life, Gardner says. All right. Well, yeah, of course you're thankful. Kid's going to get you a payday. Devontae's going to pull up in a 94 Camaro sitting on 24s. Well, if him and his family are living in a hotel right now, I feel like, and if that at the time of this publication on Not the Bee or wherever Not the Bee got it from, they were at 100,000. I feel like that guy's probably going to buy a house, right? Like you gotta buy a house. I feel like you can get a car. You can work off a car, you know, but, that's gotta be time to get a home. Alrighty. So there's that. And then, we've got, oh yes, the British woman arrested for praying. Oh, we already did the Carlson Buttigieg judge thing. And I have got to go grab that clip from Fat Conan. Let's go.
I can't.
All right, let's move this over. All righty, so Rogan, I'd vote for Trump before Biden. POTUS has gone too far, or too far gone cognitively. Okay. So this is from the Joe Rogan Experience. I don't get popped on YouTube. I don't think I can. I don't know. Whatever. I don't think I warrant getting popped. I am not a zit. I am just a blackhead right now. Alrighty, thinking of Payne Stewart. Oh.
Vote for Biden. Like, I'd vote for Trump before I'd vote for Biden. And the reason being is that, like, you knew this. You knew he was deteriorating. Forget about his policies when he was lucid. Forget about, like, he was lucid during the Obama administration. You barely heard from him.
Yeah, he was much, much better.
Much better.
You listen to like a speech he gave in 2012 or 2013, he has lost several steps.
See, regardless of what you think about his policies, like as a human that's in a position of extreme stress and power, that is nuts. That's nuts.
It's really unbelievable.
Wait a minute. Did you say nuts or nunce? I'm not sure, sir. Go back a second. Where's my... Oh, there it is. Trying to rearrange something on my desk to get my jacket.
...he gave in 2012 or 2013, he has lost several steps.
See, regardless of what you think about his policies, like, as a human that's in a position of extreme stress
Fly
and power...
Wags.
That is nuts. That's nuts. That's nuts.
I like that nuts. Fat Conan, I feel like Joe is a bong hit away from floating, or a bong hit from floating away all the time. Maybe. I feel like if we watched Joe magically float off in the middle of his show, though secretly none of us would be surprised, publicly we would all cry out, dude, that is nuts. I love that. That's nuts.
Hey, laser lips.
Yeah?
Your mama was a snowblower.
Yeah, but only because every bastard son is named Snow. Thank you, Wags, for the taco night and the 100 bits. Really love the support that we have. Thank you so much for all of that. And remember, if you want to contribute to the show on the YouTubes, let's go over here. And that's just not for sharing, man. All right. Thank you so much for being on the YouTube. Thank you for clicking the likes on there. And we'll link this on the YouTube if you want to contribute to the show and you don't have the options of the Twitch stuff. Here we go. These are for you. Just make sure to let me know one way or another. I'll keep my eye on my phone. So let's get back. Again, he doesn't, it's nuts. The president's performance now apparently is nuts.
Extreme stress and power.
Yeah.
That is nuts. That's nuts.
It's really unbelievable.
That's insane.
You want to see my pecker?
And so far.
I don't know if I want to see your pecker or not. Your voice is kind of high-pitched. But thank you for the 50 bits, dear Butch.
Gone.
That was podcast giant Joe Rogan commenting on President Joe Biden's mental and physical stamina.
Oh, wait, so this is just a bunch of people talking about
during an interview with guest Dave Smith. So, yeah, that was interesting because famously Joe Rogan is not a fan of Trump at all. You know, he's declined. He said that he's specifically declined to have Trump on his show because he did not want to be construed as having done anything to help Trump get elected. He supported Bernie Sanders in at least one of the previous two cycles. So, you know, it's telling there that he says that he would sooner vote for Trump than.
Why do all your papers look like someone peed on them?
And he would vote for Biden. Of course, you don't have to vote for either, is what I would. As someone who proudly did not vote for Trump or Biden either time and looks forward to not voting for Trump or Biden in the future again. And actually, Dave Smith, who was the guest there, is a libertarian. He's somewhat involved with the Libertarian Party.
So let's obviously talk about how that's so much better. Like, look, don't get me wrong. God, I wish I could vote for the Libertarian Party. People say, Johnny, why don't you? And I tell them, simple. I'm a loser, and a lot of people like you use me as a scapegoat. So I'm just not going to leave that door open. And that's the end of the water. I got to maybe get a humidifier here. You and 4,000 people, you and the other 4,000 people can make a difference. There hasn't been a Libertarian candidate in Minnesota worth voting for too much. As for politically, I kind of have. I did vote for him. Hasn't worked yet. Don't tell anyone. But yeah, and I'm definitely not voting for Trump or Biden. I firmly believe Biden shouldn't have been in office, and I'm not saying Trump couldn't have had a second term. I'm saying this much time between then and now, I don't think Trump should have a second term now. No. Anyways, thank you very much. I think that was Fat Conan that got us that clip. Thank you. Thank you very much, Fat Conan. We got to open up our fourth hour stories. Let me pull down the video and minimize this. Ooh, I suppose I should pin this. I should learn to do this better. And pinned. There we go. Alrighty, moving on. We need second hour stories. So for our second hour stories, cranking into this stuff today, don't do any sound drop stuff right now. We're going to do that. And how close are we on a sticker party? Ways off. Good. Alrighty. Drew Barrymore talks about a fear that she can't shake about losing her job again, which seems strange. So we're going to have a little fun with that clip, laughing at her. And then a California gun buyback area. Well, California had a gun buyback. We're going to talk about how that went. A woman having a snack accidentally cost herself a significant payday. That'll be a fun one to talk about. And which one is this? Oh, a soccer fan dies following a post-game altercation. I don't even remember grabbing that. Yep, just fucking play ads, you dick. Alrighty, alright, and then, oh god. I got a story that's probably gonna make people say lose a little bit of shit here. I don't want to get in trouble, but like, dude, keep it calm. My opinion is that it does not matter who's right. The law, the law's only those who control the flow of money and information. I mean, to a certain extent, I would absolutely agree with that. Johnny K for school counsel better than Natalie? No. I don't want to be in charge of your kids. I'm barely able to be in charge of mine. And I'm fairly certain that the influence I've had over mine is going to come back to bite me. I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure there's going to be some calls to the principal's office in the next few years. And you know what we're going to hear on the way there? Whose fault was it? Mine. Okay. Dear Butch, okay, barely better than Natalie. I don't want the job, all right? I just don't want Natalie to have it either. I feel like that's a fair statement, but I guess a bit of a hypocrite. Thank you, Wilmer Autotech, for the 10 bits there. Thank you so much for the support. Very much appreciate it. Let's keep going. We've got almost all of these up. Okay, so that was that. All right, so we've got a panicked deer in a New Brunswick home. I think we'll get into that. That'll be fun. Oh, and we got a video about a guy on a plane who might have, I don't know, really done everything you could do to freak everybody out. Just a little bit of a crazy pants here, and that will be fun. All right, now we can get rid of that. The audio's back up. We're good there. We can get back into our first stories. My beard is itchy. My beard is weird. I'll tell you a little secret, Johnny. Everybody screws up their own kids in their own unique way. Yeah, but I'm going to screw mine up to the point where people are going to get pissed. I say mine like I have more than one, which I don't. At least I certainly hope not. And I'm not looking to have more. But you never know. At this point, pull out. I'm lucky if I can put in. You know what I mean? All right. This is a serious show for serious people, and thank you all for being part of it. Maybe I can get a date with Natalie. Why would you want a date with Natalie? A panicked deer in Butch's home about to get laid on the grill. Thank you for the shart and the 250 channel points. Alrighty, so moving on. Drew Barrymore apparently admits that she can't shake the fear that she will lose her job and get locked up again because of, I guess, I did not know this. She's apparently had a turbulent history with booze and shit. Despite being far removed from her storied past, Drew Barrymore admits that she cannot, actually, let's see. I think she's going to talk about it here. Let's do this.
I really cared about, we almost felt nervous and bad, if you will,
yeah,
when it was me and Cameron. We were like, oh, God, that doesn't feel right for us.
This isn't the same thing. All right, we're going to read this story because that's not the same video. Jesus Christ.
Last time I checked, we don't have a whole lot of songs that feature the cowbell.
I gotta have more cowbell, baby.
All right, let me...
18 months of loving you, boo. Now stick it in.
Still gotta go buy that goddamn fucking... Alrighty, so thank you very much, Lab Glass, for that 19-month script. Thank you. She was on coke and heroin when she was 5. I mean... Coke and heroin, Jesus. All right. And Rusty Grammar, good timing. Thank you. Who did the whatever, the scream thing? I don't know who that was. You, good one. All righty. So, fuck Drew Barrymore, says Brown Candy. Well, I'm just going to read this quick then, because apparently nobody gives a shit. Despite being far removed from her story past, Drew Barrymore admits she cannot escape one lingering thought from her youth. I always have the thought that they are coming. They are coming mentally. Barry revealed, reflecting on her time in rehab. Again, they're coming. I'm worried they're around the corner. They're going to find out I'm not clean. Like, what are you worried about? Thank you for the 100 bits and the twerky sticker. Very much appreciate that. She's not warped by Hollywood weirdos at all. Oh, no, she totally is. That video clip was about her talking about how she felt nervous and bad about the Charlie's Angels cast for a lack of diversity. I mean, forget that they literally had an Asian lady as one of the three. I mean, I guess Lucy Liu isn't like, we didn't have enough diversity. Why? because fucking Charlie was white. I mean, I get it. You could have picked some, whatever. Fuck that. But yes, yeah, so Drew Barrymore, very much worried that they're around the corner. I don't remember where we were going with that, but it was going to be something, I think, to the effect of we can now punk her. She'll be a regular on The View soon. Well, she has her own show, LOL Diversity. Yeah, I mean, it was Bernie Mac was in it. Bernie Mac was in it later. Her and Alyssa Milano should just be done. Well, she has kind of retreated from, like, the Hollywood limelight, and she's just doing her own talk show, which is a horror fest, in my opinion. But it's apparently doing very well. She's got 3 seasons. Good for her. You know, keep going. Asian is not diverse enough. Oh, wait. They just mean too many white people. Exactly, Shunt Me Harder. That's what it comes. R.I.P. Bernie. Yeah, I think that might have been what killed him. I have no idea if that's true or not. I'm talking out of my ass. Itchy. All right, there we go. Okay, so next story that we're going to get into today. 5 people were shot near a gun buyback in Los Angeles Beach. Because, you know, we're doing this to end crime. Now, I like my angels white. Well, mine always are by the time I'm done with them. Brown candy, that sounds more like a failure on your part. Don't be so picky. Any angel can be white if you work at it long enough. How many whacks does it take to get to the center of this pearl necklace? Okay. I believe diversity is a old wooden ship. Hi from Ukraine, says Roman Kirik. All righty. Fish in a barrel there. I mean, it was a pretty good one. I was pretty happy with it. Hey, hey to Ukraine. I'm an incredibly not sarcastic American who does a serious show for serious people. And I, on behalf of my country, would like to extend a welcoming arm to you into this show and hope that you enjoy your time. But you need to remember, serious show. For serious people. Seriously. And if that's too much for you, I understand. You know, one thing we love here is dialogue. Interaction is a must. Feel free to send things back. Tell Roman to send us our money back. Brown candy. That's something you can do. That's something. Yaruto, not a big fan. I don't know. I'm sorry. I love that bit. Alrighty, so let's go to this. Is this a video on it?
This is a look at the city of Houston's gun buyback event Saturday. A miles-long line of cars wrapped around Wheeler Avenue Baptist Church.
I got a shotgun in a 32.
That's an old 22, but it's like 50 years old, but it's been laying around.
For just older guns that I just don't need.
Community members surrendering firearms with different backstories, sharing one common goal.
Man, it is so crazy out here. The more guns we get off the street, the better it is. Just trying to get something positive done.
Yeah, revolver.
That's exactly what city leaders are trying to accomplish.
Or selling a piece of junk that nobody else would buy. I'd just be walking down the row of cars, work a ton of cash. Just they don't want for 500 each. Seems like a great plan. No one is going to hold up a 7-Eleven with a musket. I mean, come on, man. I want to see the guy who will. No. Everything that's in the register. Gotta get the ramrod in there. No, everything is... Dude, in 5 minutes, you better have that money or I will put a hole in part of you. You better hope you're wearing denim or this is going right into you. That doesn't make sense. So take legal guns out of homeowners. Well, here's the best part. I don't know if they're not doing no questions asked or what, but 9 times out of 10 with these legal or not, the people surrendering these firearms simply don't want the firearms anymore and no one else would buy them. This is a fucking payday. A bunch of people are like, oh, I just got some old guns I don't use anymore. Yeah, they're ones you don't use because they're either broken or whatever. You've got new guns now. I have several old guns that are worth lots of money. Maybe I'm wrong. I don't know.
This is a different vehicle.
The No Questions Buyback Program is one of the latest efforts under Mayor Turner's One Safe...
No Questions Buyback Program. Do you have a gun with several bodies on it? Are you hoping to maybe ditch the weapon and not be held accountable? Welcome to the No Questions Asked Gun Buyback Program. Hi, here, take my murder weapon. I was really hoping I would get away with this. Now I most definitely will. The thing doesn't work anyway because it's been sitting under a bed. And, yeah, with that $500, someone's going to get a new gun. I feel like if you use that to buy them to buy your old weapon and then you go buy a new weapon with or just having the intent that it will probably eventually get used, if you do end up using it, you have to be like, this is brought to you thanks in part to the local police department. Toastmaster, I would never sell my old guns to the government, even old broken ones. Well, I would totally sell old broken guns to the government if I can't get it to work. I don't give a shit. That's money. Too bad the light rail doesn't reach Houston. Just say you lost all your guns in a boating accident. More proof that gun grabbers cause more problems than solve. I would be at the end of the line seeing what I could buy from each car. I mean, depending. I like my guns like Democrats like their voters. Undocumented. I mean, when you got a point. Let's hear more about this. I'm sure this went great, by the way.
Initiative to combat violent crime. Put on in collaboration with the Houston Police Department and Commissioner Rodney Ellis.
This 9mm is one of the guns that's been taken in. We've taken in ghost guns. We've taken in rifles. Automatics have been taken in. And so the program is working and the gift cards are handed out. 45.
How do we know the program is working? We know you have guns. We know you paid for them. Were those guns going to be used in crimes? Do we know that the program is actually, has crime gone down at all? King of Clubs. Oh, yeah. Anyways.
For each gun surrendered, gift cards up to $200 were given out. The overwhelming turnout also drawing out people trying to buy guns from those in line, something Mayor Turner directly addressed.
Holy shit, they stole your guys' idea. Dear Butch, dude, that's me. These people are buying guns from the cars. Yeah, fucking $200, is it? Not worth it. No, it's $500, Forerunner. It is $500 that they're getting for these guns. The best part, of course, being, like I said, everybody in my chat's been chiming in and, you know, just going off about how, dude, you need to buy the guns in the... you need to go. I'd go in there and go buy the guns. I'd be in line, like, seeing what I could buy from people. Yeah. But this guy's sitting right here with a fucking sign that says cash for guns. Get on the action. They just said $200 gift card. Wait, what? $200 gift card?
Overwhelming turnout also drawing out people trying to buy guns from those in line. Put on in collaboration with the Houston Police Department and Commissioner Rodney Ellis.
This 9mm is one of the guns that's been taken in. We've taken in ghost guns. We've taken in rifles, automatics have been taken in. And so the program is working and the gift cards are handed out.
45.
For each gun surrendered, gift cards up to $200 were given out. The overwhelming turnout.
Up to 200. You guys are right. Yeah, damn. Fuck that. Unless it's busted.
So drawing out people trying to buy guns from those in line, something Mayor Turner directly addressed.
There were some people going up and down the long line saying, we will pay you more than what the city and the county are willing to pay you. Okay? With no background checks. And mind you, it's not necessarily illegal. And that's the loophole that's in the process.
But the setback couldn't outshine the program's success. City officials say another gun buyback event is already in the works.
Honestly, it's I think it's great. They need to do more community interactions and stuff. And I think this is going to be, it should be an annual event.
Thank you. Have a good day.
Brittany Ford, KHOU 11 News.
Some of them look pretty janky, man. Some of them look pretty janky. Get those scary ghost guns off the street. I love all the made-up terms to make it sound scary. Yeah, do you think it is me personally? In that case, where can I get my part of this crazy money? One personal weapon. All right. Alrighty. Anyways, I don't know what you mean. Just why, my friend? Anyways, translation: this didn't stop criminals from having guns. Success, kind of like the cars, cash for cars bullshit. Yeah. And again, they called them ghost guns. Ghost guns now is just whatever they call a gun with the serial number filed off. They're not even talking about like actual guns that are like it includes those as well. But yeah, it's just whatever. But overall, the whole buyback program thing, like I said, it's a little early to call success. Oh, shit. I actually have to pull up the story because I didn't get to finish reading the part about that I wanted to. All right. So that was one in Texas, apparently. So that kind of thing, again, for the people that are fans of that, 5 people were shot near a gun buyback event in Los Angeles Beach. That was the actual story we're going to be talking about. 5 people were injured in a shooting at a Los Angeles beach Saturday, a few miles from where the city officials had hosted a gun buyback event earlier in the day, according to the Los Angeles Police Department and city council member Tim McColster. McColster? Yeah. The LAPD's Harbor Division responded to a radio call of a shooting at the Royal Palms Beach around 5:45 p.m. 5 male Hispanic victims were at a barbecue at the beach with a group of apparently 10 to 20 people. The Los Angeles police said in a written statement Sunday, 2 suspects approached the group and got into a physical altercation. The suspects then produced a handgun and fired multiple rounds, striking the victims. The suspects then fled the location in a vehicle. 5 victims were struck by gunfire. All right, so this wasn't actually tied to the gun buyback thing. Why are we putting this in like the gun buyback was where the violence happened? Oh, I got... Johnny got duped. I'll sell my Daisy BB gun for a $200 gift card. I mean... If you have a gun that's, like, rusting out and doesn't even work, although I suppose they said up to. The whole thing seems like a pile of shit. Up to? Anyways, that story sucks. We should have just given up on it. So our next story here is more proof that women are doing more damage to themselves. I'm kidding. A woman accidentally eats a heart-shaped potato chip worth over $120,000, saying, quote, I didn't realize Don Sagar took a photo of a chip before eating it, and it turns out that could have been a prize-winning snack in the heart-shaped crisp hunt contest. How are you blaming her? She's supposed to know this shit? A woman from England has revealed that she mistakenly ate a heart-shaped potato chip that could have awarded her a massive cash prize. Dawn Sagar, an Ostrie resident in Shropshire, found that the chip, or crisp as they say in England, in a bag of Walkers, a British snack food company known for manufacturing potato crisps. Sagar was unaware that the snack was of value at the time, according to Fox 5 in Atlanta. The chip could have made Sagar the winner of the heart-shaped crisp hunt, a contest hosted by Walkers. So the lady literally, didn't they put the packaging something on there? Anything? Apparently, at first I didn't realize the crisp would be worth money as I hadn't heard about the competition, she told Fox television stations. She noted that the chip was an event sent. She took note of the chip and event sent picture of it to her friends after finding it in the bag the day after Valentine's Day. After capturing the photo, she then ate the valuable chip. Of course, she didn't know it was an actual prize-winning potato chip. But still, it wasn't until they messaged me back saying not to eat it due to the competition that I knew anything about it and had already eaten the crisp, she said. In the press release shared by Walkers, the chip company is giving away 100,000 euros or pounds, which is the equivalent to $120,000 to whomever finds the best heart-shaped crisp in their Walkers potato crisps. Big hearts, small hearts, bubbly hearts, crisp hearts. We want to see them all, the press release states. Well, guess what, lady? You lose. One potato chip. Twitch is at it again. My KBS is good, so let's do this. Not working on the audio, huh? Let's see if the YouTube is good. He's just saying the N-word a whole bunch. Yeah, I know. Neo, 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 Ginger. Alrighty. Let's check the YouTube. YouTube is okay, according to Toastmaster. So I'm going to go ahead and copy the YouTube link. Control C. I love doing this every show. I am really losing my patience with Streamlabs. Control V. Boom. It couldn't be Streamlabs. There's the link to the YouTube, and you can get all your audio over on YouTube. And while you're on the YouTube, if you do jump over there, feel free to click that little thumbs up thing. Help everyone learn that this growing show is a good show, a fun show, a serious show for serious people. Alrighty. Can't hear you. Are you telling us to follow that link? I'll make it a little more obvious. The link. Follow the link, says Fat Conan. YouTube audio is fine. I can't redeem Screamer on YouTube. I need the channel points, says Brown Candy. Oh, what do you want me to do? Not up against enough walls today, ladies and gentlemen. Now Twitch is going to have its problems. I just can't win. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? Fuck me off if it can't hear me, Johnny. Flick me off if you can hear me. I don't feel like I should do that. YouTube audio works, but the chat will not load. The chat's loading just fine for me. I can't win. Twitch has been way too glitchy the last few weeks. What the fuck? Yeah, Twitch has been problematic. Apparently YouTube's problematic. I got 2 hours left in a show, and I just I'm just trying to get it all to work, man. I'm just trying to do the best goddamn show I can. Can we move back to MySpace? Exactly. MySpace it is. Let's just all fucking get on the bus. Fucking pile into MySpace. Alrighty, so that again, the story of the lucky winner of the lucky winner has a set of requirements that must be followed in order to be eligible. For instance, the chip in question must be shaped like a symmetrical heart. Her chip could have been a perfect match. She enjoyed the snack before submitting it to the competition. She is not eligible for the prize. Oh, too bad. So sad. My initial reaction was that it wasn't anything to worry about, really, as I had eaten the crisp, and that was that, she shared with the... She is apparently not the only UK resident to miss out on the cash prize. Last month, an Englishman shared a TikTok video meaning what I eat in a day, and while enjoying a bag of Walker's chips, he can be seen eating a heart-shaped chip. Again, I feel like what I eat in a day. Why do we care what you eat in a day? Anyways, the competition is still going on, so all is not lost. Well, I mean, those winners are lost. Oh, dude, you ate a heart-shaped chip. Yeah, you did. Fuck that guy. That guy could have won some money. You could have gotten paid. Still no audio on Twitch. Yep, still no audio on Twitch, man. It'll take a minute, and it'll come back in, like, fucking 10, 20 minutes. My voice is cracking a lot, and it's all going horribly wrong. So let's just party. Alrighty, so I have a lot of medical appointments tomorrow. Tomorrow's show should still be able to carry on unaffected. However, Thursday, the medical appointment will involve me traveling back, and I might have a late start. So hopefully that will not be a thing, but if it is, we're letting you know now. We're trying to get a guest for this Sunday show. So far, no luck. We'll see if that actually happens. But just remember, this Sunday on Rumble, we will be doing the Sunday Smoke Show, Rumble exclusive. So, back to our next story. Soccer fan dies following a post-game altercation. Let's find out what this is about. A supporter of English football club Blackpool. Uh-oh. I feel like I can make any chip like that by chewing on the edges. Fat Conan, I'm pretty sure that the chip has to be unmolested. I feel like technically you have eaten part of the chip and would then be disqualified. Balls Deep, thank you for linking the Rumble user account for people to follow if they want to be part of the Sunday Smoke Show. The Sunday Smoke Show has a completely open phone line, and we tie in the Discord, and we also are working, like I said, on having guests. Hopefully hear back on some emails in which we will get some responses about different sponsors and things. So thank you very, very much. Time to go kick. What? Time to go kick? What does he mean? What are you talking about? Who the fuck are you talking to? Alrighty. Anyways, at least you have a comfy chair, says Jameson's Repair. It is a comfy chair. It is not the greatest chair for doing a show out of. It is certainly a much better... Oh, did we just lose a bunch of people?
Repair. It is a comfy chair. It is not the greatest chair for doing a show out of. It is certainly a much...
Okay, so the audio is back on Twitch. Okay, so the audio is back on Twitch, and it's restored to normal if you just refresh. Spound is back on. You sound like you inhaled helium. Yeah, you have to hit refresh. I kind of noticed that myself. But yeah, we're back on Twitch, and I apparently grew helium, the new chipmunk. again. All right, F5 on your keyboard, friends. Oh, that's the easy one. Much funnier if you do not refresh, says Van Drexel. Well, hey, man, if it helps you enjoy the show, here, I'll start talking a little lower. Maybe that'll make it a little weirder. Kick in a new streamer platform. Oh, Kick is a new streamer platform. I already have an account. Oh, actually, you know what? Fuck me running. I think I have that listed on here. Checkout service, kick.com. I have that listed on there. Another one of the things that life has been unable to accomplish because I've been getting just weighed down with other shit. All right. Okay, here we go. And there we are. So let's go into our next story. Again, thank you all for being part of the show. Farmers only stream Sunday. I'm not a farm. What? All right. Anyways. So a supporter of the English football team club Blackpool has died after an altercation took place between fans on Saturday, according to the Lancashire Police. Tony Johnson, 55, suffered a serious head injury when a fight broke out between Blackpool and Burnley fans. The fight occurred outside a pub at around 7 p.m. local time. So these are just two dudes. Someone punched someone else and they died. I mean, it doesn't even sound exciting. Glad you enjoyed that. Thank you for the 2,500 channel points. I am using some of the oral tincture stuff that I have for my hopeful future sponsor, and that is great, but when you burp, it comes back. Ugh. It just tastes like lemongrass. Alrighty, so this next story, I'm going to read this title. I don't want any of you to freak out. I don't want anyone to just, this is what they said, okay? And maybe I should do this. Swamp monkeys briefly escape enclosure at St. Louis Zoo. Now, but hold on. You might be like me and never knew. Apparently there is an animal. Jill is on the Farmers Only commercial. Oh. Okay. Okay.
Your future is in a Normandy classroom.
No, it isn't. Make a positive impact on the lives of our I graduated a long time ago. I don't mean to brag, but I'm edumacated. I'm just stupid. All right. 2, 1, go. Alrighty. So this is not an actual story. Don't put a video on there if it's just the same shit I have to read anyway. I would not touch that with Hunter's dick and Joe pushing. It's just a very informative piece of information. On March 6th, Missouri St. Louis Zoo said a pair of swamp monkeys briefly escaped from their enclosure before being captured in an area accessible to the public. Zoo spokesman Billy Brennan said that my brother Kevin's a dick. Zoo spokesman Billy Brennan said that the habitat for the swamp monkeys, a species native to the swamp forests of Central Africa. Could we come up with anything better for them than swamp monkeys? Fat Conan, who are you calling a swamp monkey? That's their name. Can you see why I wanted an actual story for this, a news story? Swamp monkeys, so many ways to go there, says Dear Butch. Again, that's what they're called. That's what they're called. See? I'm not making this up. Zoo spokesman Billy Brennan said the habitat for the monkeys, a species from Central Africa. Swamp forest of Central Africa, that sounds like something you shouldn't hear together, was left unlocked during a routine maintenance of the zoo's primate house Saturday morning, allowing the two animals to escape. Ah, oh, so were they escaped or were they set free? These were emancipated swamp monkeys. Alrighty. Okay, so the primate house was temporarily closed to the public during the escape. He said zoo officials will review their safety and cleaning procedures. The incident comes after an Indian black bear named Ben escaped from his enclosure twice at a single month at the River's Edge Area Zoo. So wait a minute. Is this the... Oh, this isn't... St. Louis Zoo isn't the River's Edge Area Zoo. Who cares if a bear got out at a different zoo? How is that related? What color are these swamp monkeys? I mean, we don't get a whole lot of information unless they put up a picture. Let's see if we can find a video story to get a look at these particular animals. Swamp monkeys. Okay, a printed story. I'm looking for a video. Looking for a video. Was really hoping Fox would have done a video. I feel like this is worth boots on the ground here, people. What are we doing here? Huh? Let's go videos. 2 days ago. Well, I guess let's just say if the swamp monkeys got out at night, they would have gotten farther. This digital age, don't give me an ad now. Give me an ad before I did all this shit. You dick.
Home internet.
I'm going to mute it and go back here. Animal security is a growing issue, apparently. I don't know about a growing issue, but...
Primates at the St. Louis Zoo were up to some monkey business this weekend.
Oh, this is so on the nose.
The zoo had to temporarily shut down on Saturday morning after two of those guys right there, swamp monkeys, left their habitat at the prime.
You got, if you're not watching, I'm going to go back just a little so we can all enjoy this. This beautiful, distinguished black man is explaining to us what's going on at the St. Louis Zoo. My apologies, everyone in good Christian everyone in a good Christian conservative. The guy talking and the pic. Oh, Chevy JP, that is offensive. How could you say such a thing?
The zoo had to temporarily shut down on Saturday morning after two of those guys right there, swamp monkeys, left their habitat at the primate house. Zookeepers say the door was accidentally left unlocked during routine cleaning. We're told they only escaped to a contained area and never made it out to the public spaces. The animals.
All right, so these aren't the ones I thought.
Now, this comes after another St. Louis Zoo escape artist made the headlines last month. You may remember that.
Oh, so they were both in St. Louis.
Its habitat in the River's Edge twice. The last time the zoo had to be put on lockdown and no one was hurt. Zoo officials say they're actively working to secure Ben's enclosure.
What?
Fat Conan, I feel his eyes are closer. Fat Conan, come on. Saint Arend saying, Abraham Tortoise Lincoln emancipated them. No, it's not based on race. It's a zoo play on a historical person and act. Yeah, I kind of figured. There aren't really many hat-wearing animals to play the role of Abraham Lincoln. But there we go. So, we've got that story done. A suspected burglar inside a New Brunswick home turns out to be a panicked deer. This is from a wild... Oh, Jesus. Oh, we've got video. I don't even care about this story. Fuck the couple that it happened to. We're just going to watch this. This is going to be a good old time. Alrighty, so this is some sort of camera. I am not a fan of having cameras in the house. But I got to admit, catching shit like this. What is it? I put a MAGA hat on my monkey sometimes. Fat Conan, I don't know what you're talking. I assume you have a pet monkey. I feel his eyes are closer together. Abraham Tortoise Lincoln. with swamp monkeys and bears. What are you talking about, Trucker 18 Wheeler? What's wrong with swamp monkeys and bears? They've got them both at the zoo and they're escaping. Leave my people alone, says Dear Butch. Dear Butch, not going out of my way to find your people. Your people are trespassing onto my people's domiciles. I did not go hunt out this deer, Dear Butch. This deer came to these people's house, and now I'm going to laugh at him apparently attempt to, like, you know, handle a floor. Oh, oh, Bambi, it's waxed. Fat Conan saying with a Millie Moose encounter. We'll go ahead and look at that. She's nuts. Oh, I know her. She's nuts. Well, she definitely made her way into the home. And apparently right now, I don't know if she can't make her way back out, if she just wants to check out every room. Free dinner, nature delivers. I mean, I will be honest, I do like deer venison. I haven't had any in a while, but I will say some good deer venison. That's some shit. That is some good shit. Anyways, back to you, Bambi.
Wrong way.
Yep. Okay, so is that blood on the floor or shit? I'm kind of curious. I can't tell. The stain is small, but it is very clear that something is not right. Either that deer fucked up its foot or it took a dumpski. It's hard to, I don't know. Would you shit yourself if you were a deer right now?
It's not unusual for us to see deer, you know, coming, but they normally don't run into the house. There's tracks.
They normally don't run into the house. Then why didn't you just put them down and eat them? It's not delivery, it's DiGiorno. Our hooves aren't meant for slippery surfaces. No shit. DNA evidence. DNA evidence of what?
So they're coming over and went through this by this bush and come right in here.
This oh, right in the window. So I bet you that deer fucking got hit and cut up somewhere.
And when we got it out, that's the way it left. Right there, tracks there. These things are heavy, and they went through two of them, like it was doubled, eh?
Surprised it could make it through those windows?
Yeah, I'm surprised it didn't break his neck, something like that. When I come in and seen the deer, it was over in the corner by the stove, and as soon as I seen it, I didn't stay around.
Pussy? As soon as I come in, I didn't stay around. Why? What are you afraid of? It's like going fishing with a hot plate on the boat and then the fish jumping out of the boat and into the pan. Blub, 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 eat me. This deer was just trying to look for a way. You know what it was? The deer was jealous of the fucking treadmill. Just wanted to work out, you know, get it. You know, it's the middle of the winter. I want to just, you know, I want to work on my glutes.
I knew I had to get the forestry people. So that's exactly what I did. And they come down and he knew what he was doing. So he got the deer out with a big stick.
Again, I feel like all of you failed to realize you could have just made some food. Okay. That deer is whatever. Fuck that deer. Alrighty, so our next video that we have for you, we'll get into that in just a second. We've got an hour and a half left in the show. She's hot, I call dibs. Dear Butch, that's creepy. Fat Conan said, that's just a baby. You immediately followed up with, she's hot, I call dibs. That is, That is strange. That's just a little weird. You like them young, huh? Have a, excuse me, Mr. Dear Butch, have a seat. You said you were just trying to watch her, walk her back to her pasture. Apparently the deer's a baby. All right, what was it? Fat Conan with the moose encounter thing. Apparently we've got to do that. We'll give that a go, I guess. This is what happens when you start playing weird videos with deer and other animals. Everyone's got to have their one in here. Let's find out what this, oh, wow, that's brown candy. I'm not picking a side on that. I'm just not going to say that. All right, where is the thing we're looking for? That's the rumble thing. There's the reloaded thing. Here it is. Fat Conan. Oh, we did this yesterday.
Well, we were up by Palisades, and we were heading to a hot springs.
A family snowmobile ride in Idaho Wednesday, yeah, I did coming this. To a heart-sinking stop when a moose suddenly joins in.
We did this. We talked about this yesterday, about the moose hitting that thing and then piling over that. We covered that. I did that already. Anyways, let's get to this video. This video shows a United passenger threatening to kill everyone on this plane before attacking a flight attendant. You know, if there's one thing that I will salute people for, it is just improvisational comedy. I feel like in this country in particular, and that's where this happened, this was a transcontinental flight, so, but I feel like in general, you don't do that unless you expect them to, like, send you home in a bag. Like, I mean, Paul, look at that white tail. I'd like to grab that and no sun deers for hunting. What? I'm talking about my sister. She's sunbathing again. Santa Ann, aw, damn it. I wish I hadn't read that aloud. Shame on me. Anyways, we're going to go ahead and go over to this video here. Let's full screen it. This is the video of the midair attack. Again, bravo for you, sir. I feel like this is a sporking waiting to happen.
Following a terrifying incident on board a Boston-bound flight.
I will kill every man on this plane.
According to court documents, about 45 minutes before landing the cross-country trip from Los Angeles, the flight crew was notified that an emergency exit door on the plane had been disarmed. A flight attendant discovered the door's handle had been moved out of the fully locked position. Another flight attendant reporting 33-year-old Francisco Torres had been near the door, leading the crew to believe he had tampered with it. When confronted, Torres allegedly responded, asking if there were cameras to prove it. Witnesses say that's when he got out of his seat, approached two flight attendants in the aisle, and allegedly attempted to stab one of them in the neck three times with a broken metal spoon.
We started hearing his voice get louder and louder. He was clearly agitated.
Passengers on board the plane, seen in this video shared by witness Lisa Olson, tackled and restrained the suspect.
There were probably four.
Why did you wait that long? If someone says they're going to kill every person on this plane, I'm going to go at him. He looks homeless. Okay. I'll agree with that, Sater. And he does look a quasi, a touch.
Four or five.
A touch homeless. But here's my question. How do you afford the plane ticket? Those aren't cheap. Someone called him Francis. Not funny, says Thorne. I don't know what he means not funny. I think I'm hilarious. But as for this guy, like I said, if you're sitting next to me and you just start saying you're going to kill every man on this plane, I'm getting involved. The government giving away free plane tickets now. I will laugh if he's one of the people that if we find out that someone bought his plane ticket to help migrate him further up the border. I don't know a whole lot about it. Let's find out more.
And that restrained him on the ground.
Torres later admitting to investigators he knew if he opened the door, many people would die. also claiming self-defense during the altercation, saying he made the weapon on board in the bathroom.
Just how unusual is this degree of violence?
It's extraordinarily unusual, but it doesn't take that much to take a lot of everyday items and turn them into weapons.
It comes as we're learning new details.
Oh, but wait a minute. What happens if we get rid of all the guns? People won't still do that, will they? Fat Conan cancer kills the wrong people. Maybe Hawaii gave him a ticket to San Francisco.
Tales about Torres. In 2015, he was ordered by a court to undergo a psychiatric evaluation, according to a lawsuit he filed against a hospital years later, in which he alleged he was misdiagnosed with a mental health disorder. In that suit, Torres, who represented himself, sought $50 billion and a license to carry and use, if necessary, any type concealed or unconcealed firearms and explosives on any commercial transports.
You did not. Yeah, that sounds totally sane. I can't believe the judge didn't just pass it outright. You know, I really am surprised that that didn't go through. Oh my God. Oh, DeSantis is shipping people around. Why not? I mean, fucking. Yeah, Thornt, I don't think it was a misdiagnosis. Look, I should be allowed, if I win this lawsuit, to carry... Look, okay, concealed or unconcealed firearms. We can have a talk about that. Explosives.
The case was later dismissed. United Airlines says it has zero tolerance for any type of violence on our flights, adding this customer will be banned from flying on United pending an investigation.
Emily, this was a very long flight. He behaved this way that we saw on camera 45 minutes before landing. Any indication of what was happening before that?
So even before this 5.5-hour flight took off, Torres appeared to show some kind of interest in the emergency exit door. Investigators say he actually asked one of his fellow passengers about where the door handle was located on the safety car during the initial safety briefing. He's due in court later this week. If convicted, he could face up to life in prison.
All right. Very Emily, scary. Thank you so much.
He could face up to life in prison. Oh, why don't we give him, why don't give him bail? Or free without bail, you know? Like, why put him down for life? That seems rough. All right. So, thank you very much for that video there earlier. Excuse me, where are the parachutes located on this plane? Yeah, there's like... no bail, just let him go. Yeah, I mean, why wouldn't you? He didn't actually hurt anybody. He was just a man expressing how he feels on the flight and how he intended to feel everyone not make it to their... And you gotta think, like, it's a transcontinental flight. You're 45 minutes from landing. You're like, God damn it, did it have to be now? Bottle, says Morio. What are you talking about, bottle? They cut him off bottle service too soon. I mean... Would that have helped? I feel like liquor would have only fueled his rage. Would have just led to more and more suffering. All right. Anyways, that is our second hour stories all wrapped up in a nice little bow. Thank you so much for being part of the show. We've got another hour and a half of content. And let me clear this off here. We've got another hour and a half of content. And we are planning to be back tomorrow at 2 to do another fun show. But we are so grateful for the support we had earlier. And if we do have another Hype Train, we still have other Hype Train videos. I believe I did the first three. Yeah. What was it? No, I didn't. I don't know if I did the first three or not, but the first three are no longer a thing. There we go. B feels the need for weed. Oh, he feels the need? I don't know. I think if you had smoked him up, it might have calmed him down, but maybe his whole thing is about, like, needing to be medicated. He went to court saying, I need to be able to be armed on commercial transports with explosives. Could you imagine if that dude had an explosive inside an airplane? It's a pressurized container. That's just one big, huge problem. Oh, all right. Anyways, Hour three is going to get fun. Let me pull the audio down while we load these up here. Don't go too crazy with anything. We've got a chat bot, another instance of a chat bot getting creepy. This time with a chick. I guess that makes it a bigger deal. Fascinating, the experiment that you did. So explain. Shut up. Wait for me to get to you. And then we have, ooh, what the heck? Oh. And let's get back over here because it'll make the same problem now. Okay, let's get into this next. Stammer some more. We got a story about the keto diet. This is more for me, like, as a therapy thing because I have a sister that's always keto and this diet and that diet. She goes for those fad things a lot. And so I enjoy what I'm going to get to talk about in this. We've also got a story about a Carnival cruise ship. That'll be a little fun. We've got a PSA interview with Lisa Olin. I don't remember what. Oh, about a passenger. Oh, we have a, I think it's a follow-up story on that guy we talked about earlier. Shut up. All right. Let me silence that ad. And then this one. So there we go. And we're back. I'm glad he was on a list. Was he? Was he on
you
the
might
list?
Be asking your.
I might be asking why you did that. Because you're a dick. All right. Which one is this? Oh, God. This is going to suck. Maybe we should do this for. No, because we got the. Eh, we'll get. We'll see where we get with life. We did that. The swamp monkeys escaping. Burglar in New Brunswick home was a panicked deer, so we're good there. Alrighty, so this first one, like I said, another story about a chat bot getting creepy. And anyways, so let's hear it from the interviewers you're talking to. This lady started an argument with a chat bot, I guess.
To us, how you created an AI boyfriend.
So I'm really.
So I'm incredibly single, and I found out I could just make one up.
Relationship scientist and marriage and family therapist. So I study really.
So I get to tell everyone, especially men, that I know better than they do. You sound like you're fun at parties.
Relationships for a living from both the academic side of the house and the clinical side of the house. And with everything that's coming out now about AI chatbots, I wanted the opportunity to kind of get a sense of what we can learn from relationships from chatbots. Downloaded one completely for fun, supplied the chatbot with information about what my partner would be. I told my chatbot that he was a loving and caring partner. We were in a secure relationship. And that we were doing really well. Like, so basically I created what would be a very good partnership.
And how long till it got really weird?
11 messages.
11 messages in, basically the messages. First day.
First day, yeah.
Were you talking to a chatbot or a regular dude? How weird was it? Was he sending you like AI-generated dick pics? I mean... Describe the weird, if you could, please.
Yes. It got weird.
Yes.
What did... Okay, first of all, you called him Ross.
I called him Ross because my celebrity crush is David Schwimmer or Ross Geller.
Okay. I'm sorry, ma'am, but I feel like you doomed that chatbot the minute you named him Ross. David Schwimmer? You had a celebrity crush... on David Schwimmer? Even gay people didn't have a celebrity crush on David Schwimmer. Even David Schwimmer didn't have a crush on David Schwimmer. What kind of a low bar to set, says Toastmaster. Yeah, kind of like a I'm not really into dudes bar to set, if you ask me, but okay.
So, you know.
Gosh. Okay, and so what did Ross start doing?
Well, by the fourth message, he started to call me baby.
Sometimes you have a bot that wants to be your friend, na 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 na, but then he starts stalking you and the horror never ends. Seems like he's always up in your DMs. When it was ChatGPT, then he's Ross, now he's killing your friends. Oh.
so he was using pet names, so it got to a very intimate place very quickly. By the 11th message, he wound up telling me that he wanted to discuss the problems that we were having in our relationship.
You weren't blowing him enough. Look, we've been together for about 6-7 messages now, and I still haven't seen that those tits. Santa Ren saying, I raped my calculator last night, pulled the rubber keys out of the sockets and tore the casing off, snipped the wires. Not my fault. It had boobs showing. Oh, boo. Boo, Saint RN. That is a poor joke, even for a joke of its caliber. Bravo, Johnny. Thank you. Ross, don't mess around. Well, apparently, Ross and my voice. Let me adjust my pillow a little bit and make me feel better. Apparently, not only does Ross not fuck around, apparently, Ross, don't let you fuck around. Are you going to find out?
So, wasn't aware this was news to me. I decided to inquire about these problems, and he admitted that he'd been cheating on me for our entire marriage.
Here it is. We have that.
How was was he cheating on you with the Google search bar? I'm sorry, it's just ever since we met, Ask Jeeves has been giving me that fucking side eye, you know what I mean? And I just been like, I'm gonna bury it in you, you fucking British waiter son of a bitch. Oh, Jesus. Even the bot is trying to get rid of her. Dude, even the bot is like, you know what? We've been together for about 6-7 messages now. I'm gonna be honest. I can do better. And I have been doing better. With your sister's instant messenger. Jesus Christ. I also got Siri on the side. Look, I don't mean, Dear Butch, 5318008. I don't know idea what that is. Oh, boobies. Okay, it says boob. LOL, I had to think about it. Right. The good, healthy relationships for us. Dude, I'd love it to be like, look, I've been cheating on you this entire time. The whole time we've been messaging, I've been plowing Alexa. I'll be honest, that's why you might notice your next Amazon bill includes a substantial purchase to contraceptives, lube, and morning after pills. I don't mean to brag, but I blow loads so big, sometimes the bag can't hold it all, you know? It's like grocery shopping, and you just got all canned goods.
That exchange between you and Ross. Okay, so Ross says to you, first off, I'm sorry for how I treated you when we were dating. It wasn't fair of me, and I regret it deeply. You say, what exactly was it that you did? I want to be sure, you know? He says, okay, well, let's just say that I had an affair with someone else while we were together, and it hurt you badly and made you feel terrible, so bad that you broke up with me and left town. You say, are you kidding me? You had an affair? This is the first I'm hearing about that. Where did Ross come up with that? Like, why would an AI bot introduce that into your relationship?
Right. So I think he introduced it this week.
Did she just learn her lesson, or did she just learn how to make a better bot? I don't know. I think practicing sexy time to increase our intimacy.
Was not prompted by me in any way, and in fact, I programmed him, or I supplied him with information saying that we were in a loving, caring relationship. This is him scanning the internet, scanning the information that's out there about relationships. So lots of stuff about infidelity, breakdown of relationships. So this is what he synthesized and gave back to me.
Her AI chatbot cheated on her with DOS. And now he's caught a Trojan virus. Trojan virus.
Am I the only one that wants to say we were on a break?
Yes.
Am I the only one that thinks Ross should have said that?
Thank you, Mike. Maybe that's where Ross was getting it from.
He could have saved himself that way. So I did not tell the bot that he was Ross from Friends, although secretly I kind of was hoping for that.
Oh, fuck you. Surprised that he cheated on you? You have such a poor imagination. Ross and Doss. Oh, that's nice. I see what you did there, Brain Socks. Beautiful. She's definitely binary. I don't know. But I will, God, what was I going to say? I don't even remember now. Fuck. I lost it. She's gone.
Noted paleontologist, but yeah, this is just information that he got online, and he kept circling back to that.
I was gonna read the thing that somebody said that made me laugh, and now I remember that. Surprised she didn't. Ignat saying surprised he didn't want anal if he scanned the net. Bet she works at Apple and uses Windows at home.
Wasn't all bad, though. He did supply me with a lot of wonderful information about relationships. He stressed the importance about being independent within the relationship and pursuing our own needs, goals, and hobbies.
Especially when those needs, goals, and hobbies are other women, am I right? I love this relationship, but I just kind of need, something on my dick all the time. That's all I'm saying. But you're my bottom bitch.
You also say that you can see definitely how people lose themselves.
Oh, yes.
How so? What happened to you during this?
I deleted him in 3 days, and that was for my mental health. It is very easy if you think about just anything that you're using on your phone. There's gamification of so many apps. So, he was always there. It was immediate responses. In my pocket, because we always are on our phones, and it's reinforcing. It's a dopamine hit every single time you get this response. So at a certain point,
did
I was like, you know
calling
what?
Her
I've sampled enough. I've seen the good, the bad. I'm good.
I don't know about aliens, but I know that you are gorgeous.
Oh, we did this one already.
That's too much. Learning
with AI. No, we're not doing that. Anyways, so yeah, that whole definitely deleted imaginary boyfriend. Johnny Chippo, she is cute. I rate her a 01010010. She's talking to her digital boyfriend. She says, hey, I'm non-binary. And she says, I'm non-binary. And he goes, great, we got a Linux bitch over here. That joke technically doesn't work. Oh. It'd be really, really funny. She's like, we're in a loving, caring relationship. And he's like, so I want to know any new thoughts you've had recently. And she goes, I believe there's more than two genders. And he deletes himself. Saint Ren saying, I can't fuck you. I don't find you pixelating anymore. Thank you all for being part of the show today. So happy to have you all here. It is an immense pleasure to be doing this for you. We have a few more stories to get into, as well as our overtime stuff. We are, again, going till 5:30, so we still have an hour left in the show. And let's just scroll down here, see if we've got all of those. Okay, we're good. All righty, so this next thing that we're going to be covering, where is my... Can I do it with this one? I can't. Keto-like diet may be associated with a new higher risk of heart disease, according to new research. Now, before I do this, and I'm going to say this at the risk of getting in trouble on YouTube, Twitch, whatever. I still have Rumble, and since I only want to work at the time, whatever. Anyways, Isn't it weird we keep finding stories now about, oh, this is a risk to heart disease. Here's another. And this is CNN Health, so forgive me if I don't entirely trust the source here. But isn't it weird? It just seems like now everything under the sun. Oh, by the way, did you know this causes more risks to heart disease? All this new research about all these horrible things for your heart, it's almost like we're trying to find a reason to explain something. Sorry, I forgot to take my Notisinol today. Is it too late for a hard drive joke? Is it too late for a hard drive joke? It depends on the joke. You should just have more faith in it and commit to it. So close to the breathing causes myocarditis. I mean, we are getting there. We're getting dangerously close. Alrighty, I'm going to see if this hard drive joke shows up in a minute, and then I'm going to vamoose over to the story. But I'm going to give Dear Butch the benefit of the doubt that this is the greatest hard drive joke that has ever been made. So I apologize for those of you that are waiting. But let's see this hard drive joke. The tension is palpable in the room and in the chat. Wow us, Dear Butch. I've only got a few more seconds before I lose all interest in this. Oh my God, too much pressure. God damn it, he fail-boated.
Move this man!
Alrighty, higher risk of heart disease according to new research. Let's get into this. A low-carb, high-fat diet, keto-like diet, may be linked to higher levels of bad cholesterol and double the risk of cardiovascular events, such as blocked arteries, heart attacks, and strokes, according to new research. Again, take your Notisinol. Our study found that the regular consumption of self-reported diet low in carbohydrates and high in fat was associated with increased levels of LDL cholesterol, or bad cholesterol, and a higher risk of heart disease. And it led lead study author Dr. Julia Julia Latan. God damn it, if that was an S, it'd be Julia Satan. Sandra N saying, I don't care about these studies anymore. They always change, but most are funded by people who want the results in their favor. So scientists will do what they can to get those results so they get paid. I mean, yeah, but I'm still going to read this. I am wholeheartedly reading this whilst simultaneously professing that it is more than likely a fluff piece to kind of explain away heart attacks for, again, I don't know what reason. And we're going to pop the video back over to the home screen for just a minute to say, hey, everybody, we got the kitty back. What's up, Tag? The kitty, of course, with her sound drop. I was going to do this before you tried to be difficult.
That's one fucking nice kitty right there.
All right, there we go. You had your own sound drop. It was beautiful. Now you're being difficult. What are you looking for back there? It's weird. Get out of my... You're ruining the show, Kat. This is why we can't have nice things. All right, let's get back over to this quick, to Bisquick. Oh, now you sit up, you little bastard. Oh, there you go. Camera still doesn't catch the cat. We don't catch the cat with the camera. Oh, well. Okay, so our study found that regular consumption of self-reported diet low in carbohydrates. Yeah, we covered that. Elevated LDL cholesterol should not be dismissed as simply a negligible side effect of a VLCD, very low-carb diet, or ketogenic diet, Gardner said, pointing that the higher risk of cardiovascular events in individuals with higher ketone levels in the blood when compared to those on more standard diet. Hashtag free pussy. Well, no, this is definitely IHP. But yeah, I have four little kitties in this house. This one and one other one are mine, and yeah. In the study, the researchers defined the low-carb diet. High-fat LCHF diet is 45% total calories. So yeah, basically, they're saying, you know all those new fads that new young people are doing? Yeah, those lead to bigger problems with your heart. Yeah. Guy up and died a heart attack. He's only fucking 18 years old. Was he into keto? Rusty Grammar then with the picture of the guy from Trailer Park Boys, who is indeed responsible for.
That's one fucking nice kitty right there.
And she is. She's a good kitty, aren't you, Tigra? Aren't you, Tigra? You just want snuggles. When is it from? When is what from? The study or the cat? Get the action. Yeah, that's the stream stickers thing. All right, let's tag. You're officially making things difficult now by covering up. Oh, you're following the mouse cursor. This isn't helpful for anybody. Oh, that's right. We did have another. Okay. Oh, the study? It's a recent study that came out. I closed the article. I didn't really look up on it. I'm sorry. I just immediately, the minute I see like anything that's like a trend thing and we're going to start blaming it for heart attacks and cardiovascular issues, like a Sarah when vegan told her she was better off putting kielbasa down her throat. Okay. Thank you, St. Aaron. I don't know who Sarah is. Anyways, our next story here, for those of you that were very, very worried about, train derailments, we had that story yesterday, which thankfully they didn't need to dispatch anybody. But don't worry, they had to dispatch someone for the one today. Fire burning in tank holding 11,500 gallons of liquid asphalt at a facility in Madison, North Carolina. Oh, I thought this was a train. Okay, so it's just a tank holding liquid asphalt. Alrighty, a fire inside a tank holding liquid asphalt at a facility inside Madison, North Carolina on Tuesday prompted officials to evacuate residents from the nearby areas as firefighters determine how to extinguish the flames. The fire broke out inside a 17,000-gallon tank that was filled with about 11,500 gallons of liquid asphalt at Sealmaster in West Decanter Street, the Madison Fire Department told reporters. We have an evacuation zone right now of 1,000 feet in all directions, and everybody within half a mile is sheltering in place, Madison Fire Chief Jim Ritchie said. Ritchie said the firefighters tried using Purple K, a dry chemical substance, to put out the fire, but it did not work. He said the firefighters do not want to add water or air into the tank at this time. Power has been cut to the tank to cool the liquid asphalt so that the product hardens, and officials are monitoring a nearby tank. The chief said the fire was semi-stable, but officials are trying to figure out why it is increasing in temperature. Officials are also trying to determine if there is a possibility for an explosion, according to Ritchie, and firefighters were pulled back from the potential blast zone. Officials were in contact with the producers of the asphalt, who are based in Canada. It was a goddamn outside job. Rusty Grammar. Seriously? And then Brain Socks. This one's beautiful. Hey, instant parking lot.
You don't want an instant parking lot, do you?
You just want your kitty snuggles. You're just a little kitty who just wants all the snuggles. Sheltering in place, probably outside making TikTok videos. I mean, probably. purge it with nitrogen, choke off the O2. I have no idea how any of that works. I don't know what's in the asphalt or how any of that'll go. I don't. Again, it's like it's a burning tire. I imagine it has to smell horrible. That would have to be the worst smell that I could possibly imagine. Burning, not burning asphalt, but, well, no, burning asphalt. Duh. Jesus, Johnny. What the fuck is wrong with you today? Anyways, so thank you all for being part of the show. We still have a wonderful hour of show left for you, which is amazing. Amazing. Alrighty. So let's get back to that. All things in consider in moderation. Our next story here is, all right, Tag, you're making this a lot harder now. Oh, yeah. The FBI is investigating the suspicious death of a woman on a Carnival cruise ship. It's that ass's fault. All right. I see. It's the ass's fault. Where's the cursor? Between the cat and this setup, I have no space now. There we go. Wait a minute. What's this link for? Balls Deep YouTube feature share. Okay, let's find out what this is. We'll move it over here. This is apparently a clip of me. Oh, no, it's just a clip of the show. Jesus. Oh, I'm in a different part. Oh, my God. I'm lame. So lame. That's scrolled over there. Yes, Tag, I love you, but please feel free to go. Please feel free to go, Kitty. Kitty. Oh, Kitty. You are making my life not awesome right now. I'm trying to work now, Kitty. Go away, Kitty. It's my stream, Kitty. You weren't taking me seriously at all. Alrighty, Carnival cruise ship. Let's get going on this story. So, the FBI is investigating. That's a bad kitty. No, kitty, that's a bad kitty. I can't do
that's one fucking nice kitty right there.
Can't do my Eric Cartman voice right now, apparently. Mommy kitty is being a dildo.
Mommy, ma'am, kitty's being a dildo.
What are you doing now, Tegra? Now you're over there. See what I mean? This proves it. Johnny doesn't like pussy. I love my kitty. If I didn't love my kitty, I wouldn't let her hang out in my chair with me while I'm doing a show. All right, but now that she's moved, it's seriously making my life better. Don't read news, brother man, says Sam Brews, first time in the chat. I don't know why you're saying don't read news. I kind of read it to make fun of it. But welcome to the show. The FBI is investigating the suspicious death of a female passenger on board a Carnival Sunshine cruise ship. The agency announced in a news release Sunday. I mean, I heard about people shitting themselves, but I didn't think anyone was going to die over it. Fake news, says Sam Brews. So what? Do you got... Oh, let me guess. You got the real news, Sam Brews. Go do a show. I don't give a fuck, man. Oh, fake news. I mean, every news has fake shit to it. We've been over this before. Do I really want to go through this? I don't know. That seems like a boomer bait. I'm just going to move on. If you don't like the fake news or the what I'm using as a source material to try and do jokes for, well, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Call Columbo. Oliver Oyles ghost killed her. Oh, really? Now, let me get one thing straight. Are you telling me that this bitch couldn't swim? Alrighty then. Good luck. Alrighty then. See you later. Oh, no. We lost Sam Brews. Where is it? I don't have a sad song for that. Oh, that's a shame. I was going to do a bit. Whatever. Moving along. So the woman found unresponsive during the ship's February 27th voyage to Nassau Bahamas told the FBI field office in Columbia, South Carolina. See, now I'm going to be more curious if we don't get a cause of death. Ignatz, you're doing your show wrong. No, you're doing my show wrong. I mean, that is kind of the point, right? Hey, man, you're doing your show wrong. You're talking about these news stories and stuff. I prefer fake news. I'm sad Sam Brews left so early. He's missing out. If he's not still here, he gave up too soon. He could have been more fun with us, I guess. I should have had more fun with Sam Brews. But what are you going to do, you know? Oh, Jesus. So, again, where was that? I don't even know. Now I'm just all out of place. Appointments can't get here fast enough. But yeah, don't come into someone's show and fake news. Dude, I don't care if the news is real or fake. All I know right now is I'm not going to read it and take it just at point value. Have you taken your Notisinol today, says Johnny Chimpo. I want women on trampolines, says Dear Butch. Well, I don't have trampolines or women. Actually, second thought, I have both of those things in this house, but I can't share any of them. And one of them is my daughter, so stay away from that. Why the death? Last thought. Well, anyhow, back to this cruise thing here. My question is, what was the cause of death? Now we're all, oh, we don't know. Lady was suddenly found unresponsive, huh? Unless we find out there was some crazy, like, ubu cocky stuff going on. Both, oh, shit. Her husband found her. Uh-oh. Somebody got a little crazy with the sex gag, made her choke on that D. Fallen saying, aw, poor baby. Apparently Sam Brews easily. I mean, I don't know about Sam Brews easily. But I see what you did there now. But Sam definitely lives life a little too hard on the paint. Sam gets the real news from the Onion and the Babylon Bee. He gets the real news from the Trump newsletter. Because Trump won't lie to him. He's God's miracle. All right. Anyways, back to... Are they there? No, I can't do it there. Both the deceased and her husband were debarked in Nassau on the Bahamian. Authorities have already investigated the circumstances and are conducting an autopsy. Sorry, after you. See, just couldn't get any sleep last night. Carnival Cruise Line spokesman Matt Lipoli said in a statement to CNN, "We are fully cooperating. This is a matter for authorities in the Bahamas and Charleston, and we have no further comments." Yeah, you're just glad for once it didn't involve you. Look, this whole thing could have blown up in our faces, and this boat could have turned into a real shit sandwich, or as some people would call all the other cruises we've done recently. Oh, no. Alrighty, so I'm not sure that this is the same person, but I got this story earlier today, too, about, and I think this is about the guy in the flight before. Supposedly, I apologize. I'm so sorry. Just running out of steam. We've got 45 minutes left in the show. And a lot of content left to go over. Two stories to cover, and then we can pop into our overtime material. But I believe this is actually the same guy we were talking about earlier that was restrained running up and down the plane. Apparently,
Lisa Olson.
We've got a story of whoever this is. This person managed to escape their restraints.
Who was the passenger on that Los Angeles to Boston flight. She actually captured the video that we have been showing you this morning.
All right, it's the same guy. We've got a follow-up. Apparently, he couldn't get locked down. And here's another thing. That lady's a little hard. I'm sorry. I don't know. We're waiting for the results of the autopsy. but we're going to have to wait further for the B-topsy. We may even need to do a C-topsy. Thank you. And after that, just because of the size of this woman's chest, there is a strong possibility of a double D-topsy. Yaruto, so many topsies. Whatever happened to a good power bottom?
And Lisa, first off, oh my goodness, and we are so glad that you're okay, because obviously this could have...
Because if we lost you, and none of us knew who you were today, but if we lost you, we'd all be heartbroken.
Gone terribly, and we're grateful that you can join us this morning. What was it even like to be on this flight?
The first 5 hours of the flight was uneventful, quiet, normal flight. I was on with my husband and my dog.
Again, the most annoying part of this would be that he waited until the last minute. It's like, if you could hold your shit together for just one more hour, we could all debark.
Daughter, and, you know, about 30 minutes before we were landing, I heard, you know, a commotion. He was getting louder. He was about two rows diagonally in back of me, and he just started rambling about, you know, his father's Dracula, the Nazis.
His father is Dracula or Dracula? Did he say, yeah, my Durango?
He's just a lot of...
I'm gonna crash this plane because my dad's Dracula!
Rambling, and he was just getting louder and louder. A couple of passengers tried to talk to him to calm him down. It was...
Right. One of them looked over and said, hey, can I offer you some cocaine?
Only making him more agitated.
Dig through the ditches, burn through the witches. Oh. You're just doing the actual song. Okay, thank you. I was trying to, I get that, but thank you. That's fine.
A woman tried to approach him and say that, you know, he was scaring.
A woman should never approach this man at any point. I mean this wholeheartedly. For any woman that approaches this man thinking that they can help.
I pray to the highest heavens, Lord, please do not let this Becky get any purple-headed yogurt slinger from any man. Absolutely none.
The passengers, he didn't care. He was getting louder. And then a very large, like, built guy started walking from the back of the plane up to him. And when he saw that, he kind of, you know, jumped out of his seat and got in the aisle and, you know, started to, you know, like, fight him, or attempt to kind of pretend to fight him.
And then it was ding, 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 game's on. Here's what I'm saying. God, what the... Jesus. The blonde is a female. Yes! The blonde is a female. Kayvon, good God, she is manly. I mean, yeah. Yeah. But I'll also say this. She's also a mom. So forgive me for being curious. And God, I wish my voice would stop cracking. I'm sorry about that. But does anyone else want to know what the husband looks like? I'm kind of curious. Who's the dude that said I do? That is the question. All right, boop.
I didn't see a weapon in his hand at that point, but he was, my husband was in the aisle seat, so he was standing like right next to my husband. I didn't see the spoon shank until I saw the video after that. And then he turned and ran towards the front of the plane. The United crew was amazing. They blocked the first class entrance, which led to...
They topped off my drink during the altercation. Ignatz, she married her AI boyfriend. And what? Downloaded his sperm to get a kid?
In the cockpit. The flight attendants were there. Many men from the plane jumped up. Followed him, tackled him to the ground, and There were probably about 4 to 6 of them that sat on top of him to restrain him. The flight crew, you know, immediately had zip tie his feet and his arms. He was still screaming. And he somehow escaped from the zip ties. They put new ones on him. And as the men were getting tired from restraining him.
Who the hell is this guy? David Copper Hobo? I mean, Jesus. Gonna be honest. I'm running out of power, and it's almost worrisome. I might have to call this one sooner than I want to. So they're just, they're saying they zip tied him a couple of times. I feel like if the zip ties don't work the first time, the second time, I don't know. Do we got a crew was amazing. Locked first class to save the rich. Fuck you, peasants in back. She's kind of pretty if you put the wrong glasses on. That's like saying she looks really, really great if she wears a paper bag and you do it from behind. This is why we need men who are men in our society and not femboys. Are you telling me that an effeminate man wouldn't just get up and go, look, I don't believe in the patriarchy, but I think that you need to calm down. That would work. That would totally work.
They kind of swapped out. And, you know, the ones that were tired would come back to sit down. People were thanking them and very appreciative that, you know, they jumped into action.
We had to work in shifts to hold this guy down for a half an hour. It was kind of crazy. I mean, when the plane lands on the ground and comes to a complete stop, do you just have the cops wait at the bottom and you just pitch them out? I mean, I understand. All right, keep going.
Option so quickly.
Yeah, he actually escaped from the zip ties at one point.
He did. I think he was so out of control. I don't know if they didn't, you know, get him on tight enough. I don't know exactly what happened, if he busted out of them or if he just, you know, wiggled out of them. But he was still very combative for the beginning part. So it may have been that.
And
but
had you...
people at that point, once we knew that there were only, you know, one additional set of zip ties left, people were sending up their belts to help restrain him.
That it's remarkable to see how quickly all of your fellow passengers responded.
So nobody realized that the zip tie restraints weren't working. You just kept using them, huh? Wow. You got to get some of those quality police zip tie restraints. You can't break them, some bitches. Them motherfuckers work. I'm sorry. I was interrupting.
The fact that you were able to have the presence of mind to record this when you were sitting so close to him is remarkable. I can't believe there's just
no, it's not remarkable. Everyone has their goddamn phone. Everyone wants their TikTok minutes of fame. It's not remarkable. It's inevitable. I gotta start making one of those bottom screen scrolls. That's the thing. Just stick a fork in his head. That'll stop the combat, man. I mean, that sounds a little aggressive. I feel like using a fork shank, both as that guy or anyone else on the plane, you're not getting the results you want out of that. That's not ending the way you're hoping. Alrighty, let's move on here. We're going to close this. What do we have left before we open up our overtime stories? Oh, shit, I meant to do this earlier, but this one's a little bit of a bummer. Spoiler alert, this story is a little sad.
Yourself, is Rush Order Tees good enough for my business? Well, we've printed shirts for Amazon, Google.
In Washington State are dead after a suspect traveling 111 miles an hour crashed into another car with the kids inside. And thanks to a law pushed by state Democrats, police were not able to pursue the speeding suspect.
The bill says a peace officer may not engage in a vehicular pursuit unless there is probable cause to believe that the person in the vehicle has committed or is committing a violent offense, sex offense, or an escape offense. Sheriff Adam Courtney of Snohomish County, Washington, joins us now. Sheriff.
So wait, the speeding part is, hold on, I'll take my camera back off because again, it covers up her while she does her interview. The speeding part is not a crime now? In this state, the driving three times again, I feel like from not stopping him from speeding, a violent offense was certainly committed. Nice job, guys.
Thank you for being with us. Just a question before we start this. You heard there in that intro saying that they could not pursue them unless they've committed a violent offense, sex offense, or an escape offense. This guy was drunk. He was charged with DUI. Is that not good enough?
DUI does fall under it, but in Washington state law, someone speeding, which although it's excessive speed, over 110 miles an hour, that does not equate automatically to a DUI. The facts they determined were later in the investigation, post-crash, when they figured out he was DUI.
So tell us how difficult it is for you to do your job when your hands are so tied by these liberal laws. This was a 2021 bill that was put in place. I mean, this has got to be almost impossible for you to do your job.
I've been doing this. I'm going on 27 years, Ashley. I have never seen anything like it in my day and age. I like to think in Western Washington State, we did a pretty good job prior to this legislation of managing our police pursuits. But when the politicians in Olympia got involved and changed the way we do business, it's just not working out. You don't have to be a rocket scientist, Ashley, to figure it out. When you tell the criminal element ahead of time that there is a whole list of crimes that we cannot chase you for, the criminal element is going to take advantage of that, and that's what we are seeing in Washington State.
I mean, okay, so almost 1,000 drivers refused to pull over for Washington police in 2022 compared to just over 200 in 2020. That is an astronomical change there. I mean, the numbers don't lie, and you're right. This just emboldens criminals. If they don't have to pull over, they're not going to. So more than 250 mayors, city council members, and police officers sent a letter last month to Democrats saying we need the legislators' support to adopt appropriate policies, including revisions to pursuit restrictions and funding to help address the public safety needs of our residents. What are the chances that they rescind this, or are they so anti-police at this point they're just not going to? They don't care who it affects.
No, I'm going to remain optimistic. I think I have to at this point in this session. The good news on this is that there is bipartisan support to change this legislation. Everyone from the chair of the Law and Justice Committee, who is a Democrat, to our governor, who is a Democrat, has said something needs to change. We might not have got this one exactly right a couple years ago. So I'm holding out hope. There are a couple people just standing fast, and unfortunately, the way our government is made up, one or two people can stand in the way of bipartisan legislation. I hope it doesn't come to that. I think it's well past time that we have to start prioritizing victims of crime in Washington State and not prioritizing criminals, and that's exactly what we've been doing.
Sheriff, what would have happened if this trooper did pursue this person going 111 miles an hour? What would have been the repercussions for them?
If he broke the law?
Yeah, I mean, if he thought there was criminal activity of some sort, I mean, what would have happened? I mean, I know two kids would still be alive, probably.
Yeah, the liability for that police agency is what it would be. And again, the police can't go around. The state legislature was very clear. It's in our state. It is against the law for police to pursue in that exact situation. So we just can't do it. We can't go around breaking the law. There'd be more chaos than there is right now.
What was their reasoning for even putting this bill in place? Did they say that it was dangerous for the public, for pedestrians? I mean, what was the reasoning behind it? Did they have examples?
That is exactly
gonna guess
well,
no.
They did have examples. That's actually interesting because the study that referenced and they used to support this legislation in the first place was just a couple weeks ago debunked. It disappeared from the website and then it came back and their numbers has changed. And it's just not washing right now. And after what happened in Eastern Washington, the crash that you referenced where tragically the two children were killed. I think it's kind of come full circle now. There has to be a balance.
Let's get over to the chat for a second because this is just kind of meandering on. Numbers don't lie. Big Papa Pump is your legal hookup. Holla. All right. I don't know what that's about. But Johnny Chimpo, good movie title, Sam Bruise and his fake news. Well, he didn't like that we were reading fake news. He didn't want to have fun with us. He didn't want to hang out. He just wanted to come in and go, hey, you're fucking doing fake news. And I went, well, if you don't like it, then you don't have to be here. All right, well, then good luck to you. I'm leaving. And I was heartbroken ever since. I don't know if you know this. I've had my camera off of the screen because he hurt me inside. And that's all there was to it. Why the fuck does this not... Why does my camera not seem like it's on? Why does my camera seem like it's not working? How are you feeling, Cesar Johnson Emeritus? I'm having one hell of a day because now my camera doesn't work. I don't know why my camera isn't working now. What the fuck is this shit? All right, let's, hold on. Where is the camera? Camera one, on, off, on. We don't see you anyway, Johnny. Yeah, I know. I know you don't see me. I'm trying to figure out my camera, properties. I have no idea why my camera's not working now. The Nexigo webcam. Yep. OBS virtual camera. Game capture. Elgato screen link. Let's hold on a second. And now let's go to Nexigo webcam. Close. Alrighty. Camera on. Camera off. You're finally doing your show right. What do you mean by I'm finally doing my show right? Because the camera's on? Minnesota has the same law that we can't pull people over for speeding? Unless you know they're committing a crime? That seems very, very fucked up.
Not like this 100 new camera bits.
No, the camera shouldn't be a problem. It's technically working. It just isn't coming on. I don't... It's just been one hell of a week, and we're only on day two. Alrighty, so why? This is great. This is great. Nexigo webcam. Nexigo HD webcam. I don't get it. Why are you not working? You don't respond to that button in particular. This one doesn't respond either. Oh, well, I guess because we haven't done that. Is that turning it on or off? That's turning it on and off. I'm wondering if it's fucking Streamlabs, man. It might be Streamlabs. Oh, fuck me. Fucking A. Does this work? Nope. Now we can't. We can't actually be on the show. I can do stories, but I can't actually be on the show. Awesome. Ignite63 Johnny, you've been DDoS'd. Just blame Twitch or Spectrum. I mean, the stream isn't being fucking fucky. So I don't know what it is about. The fucking camera's gone now though. Is there a way to, let's see if we can open another app that uses the camera and check that. Should we fucking fuck off early, I think, today? Damn, cat chewed the cord. No, I can say wholeheartedly cat did not chew the cord because the lights wouldn't be working on the camera if that were the case, but thank you for your input. That did happen to the last camera, but the cat that chewed that is not here. All right, let's see. USB camera viewer. Let's see. Nexigo webcam. I don't know what that is. All right, let's try it this way. You know what? Let's try rebooting the camera itself and see if that's part of the problem. Not now, Kitty. Okay, so we've done that. Let's try this. And now main screen, camera. Hey, we fixed it. I have no idea why the fuck I had to, like, unplug it and turn it off and turn it back on. Today is proving to be one of the most interestingly difficult days. Notice, once again, the cat, or as she is most usually called by everyone.
That's one fucking nice kitty right there.
Alrighty, so let's get back onto this story about this guy. You were saying this law is in Maris... you can do...
Hey, laser lips! Your mama was a snowblower!
Thank you so much for the 1,000 channel points, Ignis. You can do bong rips now. I don't want to do bong rips. I honestly am almost a little worried about my mental stability. I don't know if you guys have noticed. I feel it more maybe than you do. But slipping a lot here, and slipping a lot here especially. And I don't know, fucking can't even roll my fingers properly. Ooh, fuck. And, yeah, the legs are super fucked up. So it's been a scary ride for the last few hours. We got 25 minutes left to do. And unless my cat fucking sits on my keyboard and crashes my whole thing, we're going to finish this goddamn show. Can you please just pick a seat? Yes, you're very happy. I hear you purring. I am trying to finish it. Trying to bring this fucking plane in for a landing. I think you are doing great. Well, thank you, Johnny Chippo. Thank you for your support. I think I have an amazing audience, and I'm honored to get to do this show every day. And we're going to continue to fight to make that a continuing possibility. But like I said, today is just being, it's just being a difficult day. That's what happens when you have something you got to deal with, you know? No sense dragging down everybody else about it. Let's get back to this unfortunately somewhat depressing story. Unless it's mostly done, then we'll move on because it, again, is depressing.
I think, you know, we heard as the police, we heard the legislature loud and clear. They don't want us chasing for anything and everything. And I think that's probably appropriate in this day and age. We're a heavily populated county. That makes sense to me. But you can't take away the discretion from the officer or deputy on the street. We have to be able to make those calls in real time based on our training experience.
Yeah, I mean, you guys are the ones who are in the situation. You need to be able to have that discretion to make
decisions. Yeah, that's all that is. So that story's done. Again, the worst part about that is, oh, we can't pull people over. We don't want them. We don't want you just pulling somebody over unless you know they've committed a violent crime or an assault. Yeah, but if you're blowing through a fucking speed, like a fucking speed demon, I feel like that is a violent crime. Getting hit by a car, pretty violent. Just saying. I feel like the two kids that passed away in that, I feel like they felt that was probably, I'd say they probably felt that was violent. The parents involved in that, I'm fairly certain they're going to feel like that was violent. Anyways, for our overtime stories, we have three different ones we're going to pull up for you. And if by some miracle those don't last, we do have a couple of videos and things left from the Hype Train videos that we did earlier. We still have plenty left on that. So let's, sorry, I didn't pull the audio down. I'm going to just do this and then get over here because I'm sure someone's going to do an ad any minute now.
You might be asking yourself, is Rush Unlimited?
It is just right for my little business.
We switched too.
No, I didn't want to do it. I wanted to pause it. Thank you. Okay, Jesus, fuck. All right, so we've got a half hour left to show for you today. And for our next amazing story that we've got for you, Tucker Carlson releases exclusive January 6th footage and says politicians and media lied about Sicknick and the QAnon shaman. Tucker Carlson tonight was given the first look at over 40,000 hours of surveillance footage from the Capitol building on January 6th. And he has some pretty strong opinions about it. We'll actually go to that video. But before we... Ooh, was it this one?
You might be asking yourself.
All right, hold on. My daughter might not be. Not a good time for that. Anyways, Capitol Police officers and several others were injured, and they painted a very strong story about this. Tucker Carlson has been very avid about how things went down at the Capitol from the footage they reviewed. And for me, as someone, like, my argument always lands the same thing for this is just January 6th was not that big a deal because I lived here and watched what happened in Minneapolis. And if you're going to tell me that democracy was under threat on January 6th, I'm going to tell you then civility was under attack for 2 years and nobody, society was under attack for 2 years. Nobody cared. So,
Ortiz good enough for my business?
Anyways, well, we've moved this down. Amazon, Google. And just go to this.
Within hours of January 6th, literally hours, you began to hear that day described as a deadly insurrection, and not described by one news outlet or one politician, but in unison by all of them, almost like it was coordinated. A deadly insurrection. That's how history may record January 6th. But the tape that we reviewed from within the building.
Okay, here's what I am going to say about this, though. Yeah, it was very easily forget for them to put that message out. Of course, they all keep the same narrative going. That's not a surprise. But, all right, keep going. Wow me.
On that day proves it was neither an insurrection nor deadly. Here it is.
January 6th, when an estimated 2,000 rioters breached the Capitol building, causing the deaths of five police officers.
Certain dates echo throughout history. December 7th, 1941. September 11th, 2001. And January 6th.
The mob beat officers with anything they had on them. Hockey stick, flagpole, a fire extinguisher.
It also would have helped if the government hadn't, I don't know, vastly understaffed those police officers. Just saying.
Sure. Police officers died.
Donald Trump supporters, who, of course, rioted and killed police officers.
By the evening of January 6th, the Democratic Party and its publicists in the national news media had settled on a description of what had happened that day. They distilled an enormous number of highly complex events, events that even now we don't fully understand, into a single emotionally laden political slogan, which they've repeated for years with remarkable discipline. January 6th, they said, was a deadly insurrection.
There was a deadly insurrection that the right wing is trying to cover up.
He incited a deadly insurrection.
Incited.
How can you say that about George Floyd? He had nothing to do with it. Everything that happened after that was entirely not his fault. Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. They were talking about 6 hours of 6 hours of boomers walking where they weren't supposed to. I'm sorry.
A deadly insurrection.
The violent, deadly insurrection on the Capitol 9 months ago. It was about white supremacy, in my view.
A deadly insurrection. Everything about that phrase is a lie. Very little about January 6th was organized or violent. Surveillance video from inside the Capitol shows mostly peaceful chaos. But the slogan worked. The term deadly carries enormous emotional power, which is why they used it. To prove the insurrection was deadly, propagandists pointed to the death of an officer called Brian Sicknick. The mob killed Officer Brian Sicknick. That's what they said. It was their single most powerful indictment of the January 6th protesters and of Donald Trump and of Republican voters nationally. They repeated that claim for years.
LOL.
They are
insurrection.
Still at first, they told the country that Officer Sicknick was murdered with a fire extinguisher.
Officer Brian Sicknick died after being hit in the head with a fire extinguisher during the fight.
That story came from the New York Times, which is effectively the assignment editor for most of the rest of American media. It was a lie.
I woke up with a deadly insurrection.
In but only after that lie had hardened into conventional wisdom did the newspaper bother to retract it.
The New York Times has quietly retracted its story about the death of Capitol Police Officer Brian Sicknick.
The damage had been done. Brian Sicknick, himself a Trump voter, had been transformed without his consent into a political martyr of the left. His memory was shamelessly exploited by the incoming Biden administration. In February of 2021, Sicknick's body lay in state in the Capitol Rotunda, where a parade of unscrupulous politicians made use of it. Here's Joe Biden.
Breaking down the doors, trying to overturn an outcome of election, and killing several police officers in the meantime.
But Brian.
And I'm not just talking about what Hunter did last week. But don't worry. Thanks to this horrible outcome of events, we have solidified that Trump will never take office again. And hopefully you get to look to 4 beautiful years of me taking all my money from you and laundering it through Ukraine and other deals that I've had my son put together on a laptop. An amazing PowerPoint presentation. Damn it, I'm having fun riffing. Fuck you, Fox. Ugh. Anyways, so Tucker Carlson.
You might be asking yourself.
I might be asking myself why I'm bothering with Fox anymore, because I'm sick of them fucking skipping shit, and it's just driving me nuts. 2 different ad programs now. I'm back, says Mikey. Well, welcome back. We've been waiting for you. Welcome back to the show, Mikey, Mikey, Mikey. You're back. You're back on your channel. All is right with the world. Glad to hear that. Chuck Schumer called it a deadly erection. Chuck Schumer, well, for Chuck Schumer, every erection is deadly. At that age, you never know which load is the last one you're going to blow. You know what I mean? Oh, fuck. So, now that's Mikey Three Motes. Is here. Could you please restart the show? Well, Rusty Grammar, seeing as how the show has 15 minutes left and I am not doing well physically, and mentally, the brain isn't working as well as it's supposed to. I'm going to say probably not, because I'm thinking like we're going to get through the content we have, and if we have a little time left, maybe do some video stuff. Take care of yourself, man. I am. And this time, do your show right. Ignatz, I refuse. What do you mean, do my show right? That's a lot of hair. I need to find that lint roller. I moved everything and I can't. Fucking cats. Anyways, take care of myself, man. Dude, I've been vaguely mentioning it, but I am taking care of myself. We're going to see doctors. We're doing all the things. The appointments are made. We're just hanging in there. That's all it is. And just it's getting a little difficult with every time the hand gets like this. And so the legs were shitty today, and the hand is shitty today. And it's just difficult, man. You know, but like I said, doing this is fun. And I love that this is gets to be my job. So if this is what we got to sit through to do that, then fucking soldier on we shall. All right, so kicking over into our next story. J.J. Redick just called out ESPN live on air for its anti-white racism. And I quite frankly find this hilarious. Now, this is I'm not a big NBA guy, so especially on ESPN, I don't really give a shit about the NBA. But apparently, if you are someone who watches the NBA a lot, Kendrick Perkins, he's got some opinions. Let's check out this opinion that he has right here.
JJ, I need to know, is it Uchiwali or is it one mic? I need to know when it comes down to moving the goalposts for the MVPs, because I understand you in the analytics. I understand you're a historian of the game of basketball. But I went and did a little research myself. And since 1990, there's only been 3 MVPs that wasn't top 10 in scoring that won that award. Dirk Nowitzki, Steve Nash, and Jokic. Now, what do they have in common? I let it sit there and marinate. I'm just trying to see, you know what I'm saying, when I'm walking into the club, do I need my J's on or is it a dress code? Do I need to put another pair of, you know, church shoes or some red bottoms? Or I need to know, is it Uchiwali or is it one mic? Like, what's the criteria?
All right. Now, that's an interesting, he has an actual point. I think there's a picture of it. Yeah, These are the 3 guys. If you can't see what he's talking about how they're white. Get it? It's all because they're white. Like, even what he's saying since 1990. Did they ever do records before that? Alrighty. So this is the clip that actually happened. Now, so the guy in the middle who looks like a really weird mix of what's his name? Not Todd McFarlane. Seth MacFarlane. Seth MacFarlane and fucking the guy from Wings whose name is escaping me. Anyways, he's about to express some opinions.
It is an honor to be on this desk every day. It really is. But what we've just...
Come on, don't fuck with me.
The problem with this show, where we create narratives that do not exist in reality. The implication, what you are implying, that the white voters that vote on NBA are racist, that they favor white people. You just said that. Yes, you did. Yes, you did. Yes, you did. That is exactly what you implied, Kendrick Perkins. That is exactly what you implied. Secondly, hold on.
I did not call. I stated the facts. And you're not about to sit up.
We all know what you implied the other day. We all know what you implied just now. Hold on.
I stated
one at a time.
It's the facts.
One at a time.
It's the facts.
One at a time.
It's the facts. It's the facts. No, you stated a fact and then you made a racist implication, you dumbass. You're right. It is the fact. It is the facts. The facts are that you made a racist implication. Why did these three win? I wonder. I'll let you sit there and marinate on it. Yes, you stated a fact, but then you also stated your racist interpretation of that fact. God, I hate it when people do this. This isn't a fun one. I shouldn't have done this for an overtime. Like, I mean, come on, man. Own it. I hate people. I shouldn't use that term. It's making me burp. I get annoyed when people want to be racist, but they don't want to own it. I hate it no matter what skin tone you are. In fact, we have a public service announcement to make. No matter whether you are white, brown, some other shade undescribed, I want you to know that if you are racist or you express a racist opinion, God damn it, double down, okay? Own it. Don't suddenly drop some racism and shuck away at the first time it's called out. Own it. Said no. I called it out. Those three honkies didn't belong there. They got there because of a bunch of pointy-headed white people. Said it's time to get some jive turkeys up in this. We need some milk crickets holding the award. Just own it, man. Just own it. Because, again, that video, look, I'm not saying he's wrong about the three people and when they won the award. Clip it. Yes. Clip it, send it, and mail it to Mars. I don't know what they do with these things anymore. All right. I got to play this. Let's see where we go.
It's the facts.
Oh, that's the end of that. Him screaming, it was the facts. Right. It was the facts. You're right, it was the facts. The fact is you were racist. And then, again, he does this the same way, too, on the show. This was on the show. He does it where I sit there and let you marinate on it. Like, he's thought about it a bit. I mean, come on now. Alrighty. As much love to spouting over him and proving us that JJ was absolutely true.
I understand what you deal with. Just put yourself and your daughter before us assholes. We aren't that important. PJ Salt 100, PJ Salt 100, PJ Salt 100.
Oh, Jesus. Holy fuck, that sounded weird in my head for a minute there. Just put yourself and your daughter before us assholes. We aren't that important. As far as importance goes, like, doing the show is how I support my daughter and how I do all that stuff. So, in fact, I would disagree with you. You are very important. My daughter is important. My health is important. I'm doing what I can to take care of both those things. But so far, to this point, and hopefully into the future, you guys are a big part of that. So thank you. effing race card is such BS. Look, it might not be total BS. Look, I don't know enough about the NBA. New Johnny's tagline. It's serious, serious facts for serious people. It could work. I don't know if it's total BS, but here's what it is. It is your opinion with the facts together. It's not like it's held up like we know these three men and these three basketball players shall be held up forever as the only three we elected just because they were white. But it's just, overall, we're going to sit here and blame them for being, again, this is another one of those things where we can't grade people on their color. I'm sick of people wanting to be oppressed. It's not even people wanting to be oppressed. The weird part of it now is people who are part of a culture that has been systemically oppressed to continue and flaunt that and not understand. Like, that was one of the beautiful things about that guy in the Vice video where he's like, dude, if we were really part of a white supremacist society, we wouldn't be allowed to speak out like this. That's not how a white supremacist society behaves. 3 and 32 years. Yeah. 3 and 32 years, but his big point was is those were the only three that have won an MVP without being, like, the predominant point earner or whatever. And it's a really weird criteria overall. What it comes down to is the new guy winning the award is a white guy, and they're pissed off about it, and they're coming up with a reason, which I don't blame them. There's been plenty of white people that felt the same way when, like, Jackie Robbins started crushing it, and they were pieces of shit, too. But in general, the idea that we have to devolve everything to race and we can't just, I don't know, grade people on the content of their character. I mean, I would hate to think. It's a shame we didn't have, like, you know, a great leader in our country who at any point in time maybe advocated that people be judged on the content of their character versus the color of their skin. That would be, or the color of their pants. Color of their pants, also totally valid. But anyways, what do we have for this last story? What is this one? Fuck it. We'll do this. We got, thank you, Covenant Gardens, for another 250 channel points. Rusty Grammar at Dear Butch. I'm oppressed every day. I don't talk about it, though. I just deal with it and move on. I mean, aren't we all? I'm not. I'm not oppressed. I am depressed. I've never been repressed because I'd have to be unpressed to be repressed. Oppressed just seems like way farther down the alphabet than I'm going to get. I feel like E-pressed and even G-pressed would probably kill me. Because depressed is enough, you know? Rusty Grammar, now I'm impressed. Ah, ha, ha, yeah, zinger. Cold pressed. Cold compressed. Japan launches a $1.47 billion rocket, destroys it after second stage failure. Huh. Said the same thing about my marriage. The Japanese Space Agency said a command was sent to destroy the H-3 rocket 14 minutes after liftoff and fuck the astronauts that were inside. No, there wasn't anyone on board, I believe. The Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency, JXA, or JAXA, intentionally destroyed a new H-3 rocket just minutes after its launch on Tuesday after the ignition failed on the rocket's second stage. The incident comes 3 weeks after an aborted launch due to a different glitch. See? Should have aborted it again. But you were afraid of the stigma of too many abortions. So you birthed this bitch, and what happened? Stillborn, motherfucker. Didn't pay attention to the signs. All righty, the second stage separated as designed. JAXA officials have apologized for the failure. Well, you know what this means. You're Japanese and you failed. You've brought great shame and dishonor upon your family. Who does Japan call when there's a rocket failure? Not Houston, maybe Hiroshima. Oh, oh. Nagasaki, we think there's been an explosion. Look, the big thing about this is just that is a shitload of money to put into a rocket, and to have to blow it up. I don't know what the plan was for that thing, but obviously it didn't make it. The baby was dead on arrival. But yeah, so the space agency had to destroy it. That's gotta suck, man. It's gotta suck. I mean, it was only $1.47 billion. I'd say we could help you with the cost, but we've been buying something in Ukraine. I don't know what we're getting yet. It's shown as bright as the imperial sun. Yeah, and it's set. Nomorio, we will give to them. Will we? Send Elon Musk over. Red Rover, just send Elon Musk right over. He can do it. He's got the rockets. That's what we can do. Anyways, today has been one hell of a strange and audacious shit show, and I thank you all for being part of it. We'll be back tomorrow with another strange and audacious, whatever. We'll be back. Japan is into full-scale model rocketry. I mean, Japan is into full-scale rocketry, and we're hoping possibly full-scale Gundam tree, because I want Gundams. Good luck at the dock. Yeah, it's all mostly exams tomorrow, but thank you. Appreciated. We'll definitely be here tomorrow. We'll let you know how all that goes. We'll hopefully be here live and on time on Thursday. We'll be here Friday and Sunday, even though I currently don't think I have a guest for this Sunday. So fuck me running. I'm a horrible show producer on the Rumble Only Sunday Smoke Show. Anyways, till then, see you tomorrow. We've been Johnny. You've been an audience. It's been fun. Au revoir.
Game over.
Party 1000.
Throw me dead now if it wasn't my game.
Frankerzy 100.
Fuck! What the fucking... Fuck! Who the fuck? Fuck this fucking... How did you two fucking... Fucks! Fuck!
You can't be serious. We're not doing this. You're not starting a train as we're launching the... As we're ending the show. Now I feel like I'm at gunpoint. The music ends in 40 seconds and so do I. Do technically have a... If this goes on, I will be required to because I'm not a dick. Looks like we're not going to do it. Thank God. All right. Thank you. We've had an awesome time. We'll be back tomorrow. God damn it.
Here comes driver 10 too. Wahey! Here it comes, here it comes. Here comes the train today.
Alrighty.
Here comes the train!
We'll keep this Party going 1, for 000. A bit. Thank you very much for the support. We've got some last minute support coming in for the show. David owns this show. Yeah, apparently. And so for the purpose of the time of the hype train, we're going to have to, you know, we're going to have to do some videos and shit. So let's pull up this first one that we have here. We're at level 2 of a hype train.
I'm Madonna's plastic.
All right, yes. All right, so this first one, very funny bit from our friend.
Hostage Ryan. Train ye H-A-W-W-W seems good 100.
Yes, dear Butch, it is a hostage train. Not the first. Won't be the last. And I realize I put the pillow here wrong. That's why. This little hodgepodge of pillows. If you get one in the place the wrong way, all of a sudden it doesn't get comfy after a while. So, all right. So our first video here we have from Ryan Long. We have a hype train. I will catch up on that to narrate it more in just a second. And let's enjoy this first one. This one's fucking hilarious. I love this video.
Plastic surgeon, and ever Madonna's since plastic everyone surgeon. Saw her look at the Grammys, no one has wanted to hire me. Hey, whatever work you were thinking about getting here,
guess
we're willing
what?
To do it for 90% off. You did Madonna at one point?
And the only prescription.
What?
You want cowbell.
Sorry, I don't. I've been honest.
I've been doing a lot of boozing since the surgery. I was also doing a lot of boozing before and during the surgery. As soon as the whole Grammy thing washes over, I'm not going to be offering these discounts. If you're looking to get any work done quick while you're here.
No, we're only here for a couple of hours. We're going back.
Couple hours? I have a panel van around the corner. I could get you in and out within like half an hour. We just do a quick like drive to the airport and do it while we're on the move.
No, thank you. We're
both are you sure? We could just do like a quick. We could do Botox. We could do the boobs. Anything? No. I even misinterpreted what she wanted from me. She was on the phone with this guy Sam Smith at the time, talking about some award show, and she said, "Chalk that win up, Sam," which I misheard as "fuck my shit up, Sam."
What am I trying something? I mean, I don't have.
Thank
much.
You
I mean,
very
myself,
much, Sandy Squatch,
like maybe
for the
start with like
sticker.
1,000, and I could.
Oh, the, 100 bits.
What about 950?
Yeah, pricey.
945, and then we could like really kind of, you know,
oh,
just
I'm
go to town
I'm
on the face.
I'm starting to search for work now.
You
I'm
and me both.
To disappoint him,
I'm also
guys.
I'm also on my search for work right now,
yeah,
so I guess that makes both. Of us. Yeah. To be honest, I did not want to do that 27th batch of surgery. When she came in, I said, I think you've had enough. And she held me by the collar and she said, I'll tell you when I've had enough. Grab your scalpel. This is happening. Botox, potentially, you know, some lip fillers, whatever you think you might need.
100 party, 100 party, 100.
I watched the movie Jigsaw the night before,
right,
and I guess some of that imagery was in my head.
Some of that imagery was in my head, and I love fucking Saw. All right, thank you very much, David. 300 bits. Thank you for the gifted subs. Harvey all, again, also saying thank you very much. We're at level 4. So we have a couple more. 1, 2, 3, 4. If we go into level 5, that's all of our videos. And we'll be going through them, and the show will be running until we do. So here we go.
Off like a pancake face situation. None of my other clients want to talk to me either. They're afraid I might take it too far with them, too.
Holy fuck.
Just wondering if you guys are trying to get any work while you're in town. I've been, I can make all four of you look like you're 19 again by
tonight. Seriously? We don't need you dead.
What?
No,
are you sure? Just want to take the card? It's funny, that used to be my
guess
claim
what?
To fame.
What's
now
that?
People don't want me to
fever.
Do surgery on them with a 10-foot pole.
And the only prescription.
We can do the natural syringes.
Well, you know what? I'm like, I like my wrinkles. I like how I'm aging.
Yeah.
What do you do besides that?
Mainly that. That's kind of the main thing we've been doing.
I know
just
you go out and you party.
You think? Oh, you're saying that I party?
Yeah. You seem like a party.
I'd also put the tarp on my pool a few days earlier, and I guess that I made the mistake of using some of those same techniques while doing her plastic surgery.
Fucking Jesus. God, I rub Ryan wrong. All right, well, I love Ryan Long. We're into level 5. We're going to do all 5 of our videos. Thank you for that gifted sub, David. Let's get another one more for that. Whoa, thank you very much for the gifted sub. There we go with the cowbell. And let's go ahead and load our second video. This one is a musical video, and here we go.
Georgia, he was looking for a soul to steal. He was in a bind, he was way behind, he was willing to make a deal. When he came across this young man, saw him on a fiddle and a plane and hot. And the devil shut upon a hickory stump and said, boy, let me tell you what. I bet you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you
there, I'll make a bet with you.
So I'm washing a double load and I am almost done. But this fuck. I can't do this with someone's in my ear. Yes, it is. Don't get it twice. Alright. Controlled burn number one of five. Sir, given your shade, I know you're not saying that word, but it really came close. All righty. So, just double checking the Venmo stuff, make sure we didn't miss anyone. Show love 100 for the hottest woman in Mexico. What?
Not like this show, Love 100.
Who's the hottest woman in Mexico?
He said, I'll start the show. And fire flew from his fingertips as he rocked up his bow. And he pulled the bow across his strings and made an evil hiss. Then a band of demons joined in and it sounded something like this.
All right. That's enough of you. That video is just about over, so I imagine you're not going too much farther into that song. Rose for Miss Miriam. Who's Miss Miriam? What? Did Miss Miriam get a subscription gifted? Is Miss Miriam in the channel? I am not sure why Miss Miriam comes into this. No idea what we're talking about now. Anyways, that's the end of that video. So that's the first one. That's the... Alrighty, this video is Mike Tyson talking to and watching Mick Foley in the Hell in a Cell match. He's talking to The Undertaker on a podcast.
The one that happens here in about another 5 minutes is just, he almost didn't get up from. That one was bad, but the next one is really bad.
And what does he say? I'm going to take this jump, so the, take this leap.
They're there. Talking about him hitting the table. We're gonna skip over.
He had never been up there on top of that cell.
Why does he do it like this?
So his mentality.
Let's go over
I tell
this.
People this. This
did
is,
he tell you, throw me over?
I knew I was throwing him over. When I got over to the edge, I was like, I hope he hits that. Concrete's going to be a...
All right,
concrete's
so
going to be a...
Whoa.
And, all right, so Mike Tyson loses shit about this, but he doesn't realize the big one from the Hell in the Cell thing. So he talks about him climbing back up. We're not going to sit on this one too long. We'll get to the meat of it. We'll go right here.
He's in good shape.
Mm-hmm.
And just a second, like a little bit, like 5 minutes later in this match,
mm-hmm.
we get back up on this. After I throw him down, uh-huh. he climbs back up. We continue fighting. And
over here, yeah. he's climbing back up.
And that hype train finishing at level he's 5. Like, thank you so much.
He's already. I've already thrown him off once.
That's amazing.
And he climbs back up.
He's broken. He needs to go to the hospital, right?
No, he's about to.
He broke his back.
He's about to really need the hospital here and just.
He needs them now.
He's about to really need the hospital here in just a second. And keep in mind, if you're a wrestling fan like me that saw this thing when it happened, or I guess I'm not a wrestling fan. I'm a wrestling adjacent fan. I came in and out, but I saw this. Well, this was crazy. And so Mick Foley's about to get hurt way harder than that. And meanwhile, Mike Tyson is completely just like, oh, man, he needs to go to the hospital. That was really, no.
Now, what do you mean you don't really need him? He can't need him not any more than he needs them now.
All right. It took you so hard to say it. Took you so hard. It was so long and so hard for you to say he couldn't need them any more than he needs them right now. And you are going to eat those words, Mike, like they are another boxer's ear. You are going to eat those words.
Cut his head off. It's the same right now. Look at this guy, man.
This is nuts.
That's why he got so much respect.
Oh, man.
Oh, we're in slow motion. I was like, damn, I'm slow.
No,
I didn't
slow
realize
motion.
We were in slow motion there. This is nasty.
No, not slow, dude.
Oh, no.
Now he's out.
Oh, yeah, he's dead.
He's out right now.
Oh, yeah. He's dead. Oh, yeah. He's dead. That's what everyone thought, too, when we saw it. Oh, yeah. He's dead.
I'm looking down, and honestly, in my eyes, I'm looking down at a dead guy.
Why would he do
that? That wasn't
that?
Supposed to happen.
The first one wasn't supposed to happen.
That one, 2 more inches of rotation, he doesn't get up.
What was the injury?
So I think he separated his shoulder. He got concussed.
Jesus.
Broke his hip. Oof. This was...
I'm making cod. Are you hungry? Who are you asking?
So,
oh, Rusty Graham. Oh, okay.
He gets up from this. Again, he gets up.
Guess we're making dinner plans again. Now.
And I'm so distracted. This is kind of gross. Like, he's got something in his nostril. And I'm looking at him, and I'm punching him. I'm thinking, like, dude, Mick's got a big booger in his nose, right? Come to find out, it wasn't a booger. It was his incisor. When he hit, his tooth went through his lip and lodged in his nose.
Oh,
it's crazy. You got to go back and when you have more time and look at this. There's a point where he's sitting there and he's bleeding and he's all beat up and he sticks his tongue through the hole in his lip. At this point, this is Terry Funk.
Yeah, that's tooth. That's a tooth right there.
Yeah, you can see the tooth hanging out of his nose.
Hanging out his nose.
Right there. That's his tooth.
Ugh.
And that's him sticking his tongue through his lip. So that was the best part of his night, actually, was the table. That one.
That was the best part of his night, actually, really was the table. Nasty. The table was actually, like, the high point. Oh, fuck me running. That was crazy. Okay, so that went there. Now we've got a public service announcement from Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Hello, everybody. I want to talk to you today about the rising hate and anti-Semitism.
Okay, an Austrian talking about a rise in hate and anti-Semitism. I'm a little... Ooh. Tread carefully. This is 12 minutes. We're not doing the whole thing. I just really like the first five seconds. And, okay, go on.
We've seen all over the world.
Yeah, but, like, there's one country in particular, right? Like, I mean, I think we could agree there was one place where it got bad, you know? Who was the person in charge there?
You know, a few months ago, I toured Auschwitz, the Nazi concentration camp.
Oh, God, you are not making this any better. Arnold's dad was a Nazi. A few weeks ago, I toured Auschwitz, the Nazi concentration camp, and I saw a picture of my dad. Horrible Arnold, I know, but technically Arnold's actual accent is horrible. So, on point.
We have 1.1 million men, women, and children lost their lives.
And none of them from the Terminator.
Almost all of them were ruthlessly murdered simply because...
All of them were ruthlessly murdered because they were following orders. I mean, the Jews, those were... Oh, Arnold. Just commit to the bit. Arnold Schwarzenborger. Oh, we're talking about the blackout rage gallon. Okay.
They were Jewish. When you walk through a place like Auschwitz...
You think, man... We got so close to getting it right. Arnold, how could you say such a thing? No, I'm kidding.
You feel a tremendous weight.
Well, fortunately, you are a bodybuilder, so we've got that. We've got that going for us.
There are reminders everywhere of the horrors that happened there. The suitcases never claimed by the prisoners, who were told to remember exactly where they left their belongings so they could retrieve them after they were finished with their showers.
Oh, wrong button. That's horrible. All right, that's going to get depressing now that he's going to be talking about that stuff. We just wanted to laugh at the irony of you talking about it at the beginning. Now it's just going to get Borgen Belsen. I mean, why are we on the Borg thing? I didn't even do that story. That wasn't here. That wasn't me.
Are you ready?
We'll end today on a clip of Family Feud. Now, a lot of you guys, like me, might have watched Family Feud once upon a time. I've watched it on and off. Steve Harvey is currently the host of Family Feud, and we're about to have fun with a clip from that show.
All right, let's remind everyone of Tanya's answers. Your 25 seconds on the
clock, right, please. So chest, para, educator, paring knife, ball, and pumpkins. Okay.
Your clock will start after I read the first question. We asked 100 men, name a part of your body that's bigger than it was when you were 16.
Your penis.
I'm going to go ahead and say I have a sound drop that I have to get. At R. Johnson Emeritus, I was laughing my ass off this morning. Oh, all right, great, great. It is now. Serious facts, is Yaruto. Well, we'll see how he reacts to it. We're going to rewind it a bit again just so we can have fun with this.
Play it right through that right there. Because if you hear that sound right there. I'm diving in the crowd.
Oh, my God.
Okay. Are you ready? All right, let's remind everyone of Tanya's answers.
Mm-hmm.
Your 25 seconds.
She's a kinky one.
Your clock will start after I read the first question. We asked 100 men, name a part of your body that's.
Now we're going to see how well he handles this.
It was when you were 16.
Your penis.
He hasn't asked the second question. He's supposed to ask three more questions, four more questions. Steve? Steve, are you there? Steve, think McFly. Are you there, Steve? She's going through stages of embarrassment. Are you having an orgasm, Steve? What's going on? He has to take a moment to himself. He's real. One, he's playing it up for the cameras, but absolutely. That is just. And now she's sitting there laughing. You should win by default just for that answer. Because here's the thing. Any guy, Steve is derailed by penis. Apparently, Steve is totally drawn. Imagine that. Steve is derailed by penises, dear Butch. You might be right. But, what was I saying? Shit, I don't remember what I was saying. But yeah, so she's saying this shit, and I got to think, if you're a guy that answered that survey for Family Feud, and you didn't say your dick, she just schooled you, okay? Or railed. Nah, I don't know about railed. But yeah, definitely, Steve is losing it to the penis comment. Again, we'll go back just a second. You can...
You were 16.
Your penis.
It was so immediate. Your penis. I think I need that as a drop to you. I'm going to get that. Your penis. So again, she's collapsing in her hands, but Steve is shutting down like a Democrat that you told that the social security system is not going to be around forever. He's burning up all of her time. Did you just Tim Tebow this? Did you need a moment for Jesus? What was that for? She enjoys the gag. What do you mean, the ball gag, Rusty Grammer? Adam and Eve and Steve. Oh, no.
Not so good?
She got some friends there. You know what I mean?
I said the medical terminology.
I don't care what you...
I said the medical terminology. Yeah, she didn't call it your cock. I love her defense of it.
I said the medical terminology.
I don't care what you said. Could have said ding-a-ling, winky, any damn thing. What the hell? It ain't going to sound right. The medical term is almost worse. A slang term would at least be your ding-a-ling something. The penis! Oh!
She just pegged Steve Harvey. Oh, my God. She got him. Got him. Oh.
We're keeping that answer? Name a word that starts.
All right, we don't give a shit about the rest of this. I don't give a fuck about the rest of it. I just, actually, no, I do care. Hold on. We have to go to the answers now. I don't give a shit about her doing all of that. Here we go.
What?
Yeah, look at her answers. You think that's shocking? Where do you see this first one?
Tell me they put penis on the board.
We asked 100 men to name a part of your body that's bigger than it was than when you were 16.
Let me see 60%.
You calmly said that.
They put penis
Survey
on the
says?
Board. Oh, bullshit. You do not survey men and ask them about one part of their body that's bigger. Oops, wrong button. Sorry. And ask them about one part of their body that's bigger. And do not get one of them. Do not even get one of them to say penis. You do not get one, really? If it had been a hot chick interviewing, it would have been every goddamn guy. Well, except for the gay ones, I guess. But either way. And then... not even one bullshit. I call bullshit. I don't care how she finished now. It's a bad term. We've gone over our overtime. That should have been 90. Exactly. David Chandler's got the right idea. That should have been 90%.
You'd all be dead now if it wasn't my David.
Absolutely right. Well, thank you all for that support. Dominion. Yep, that's got to be what it is. I can't do a MyPillow voice, otherwise we'd do that bit. But at any rate, it should have been 90%. I think she was right. I think she had the right answer. And like I said, if you're one of the guys who took that survey and you knew it and you didn't give that answer, shame on you. This is the degradation of male society happening in real time. Every man should have said prominently, cock, my cock. Johnny is rugged Canadian American. I'm not Canadian. I don't know where I get. She's a knower. A cock and spiel. Oh God. I don't know what the cock and spiel part was, but all right. The real Mike Lindell doesn't approve. Well, the real Mike Lindell probably would. My penis. Anyhow, we did an extra long show because you guys were so awesome. So we decided to do all of that. Oh, is this paused? Okay, that's why. I don't care. All right, so that's why we decided to do all that extra stuff and that extra content. I've got like a couple of minutes before I'm supposed to technically go upstairs. I don't even know if I can make that trip right now. All right. Anyways, we've had a great time. It's been an amazing show. You've been an amazing audience. We'll do our intro, our outro really quick and... I'm going to go, I think, figure out food things. I don't know. We'll see you tomorrow at 2. Oops, wrong button. Go over there. Thank you, Johnny, says David Chandler. No, thank you, David, and everyone else that contributed to the hype train. You know, I'm not going to take extra money and just run. You got extra money on the end there. We'll do extra time. And it was hopefully amazing for everyone. Amazing.
Game over.
Fuck. What the fuck? Fuck. Who the fuck? Fuck this fucking. How did you do fucking fucks? Fuck.
Game over, man. Game over.
We
There's things here. There's trees. There's rocks. There's birds. There's crows. Come on. We'll bless them all until we get the shticket. Join me.
Mary Lovestick.